What time does your clock say at home? Am I early? I think I'm about a minute and a half early, don't you? Should we just chat till we're ready? Paul's clock in there, which is the clock we go by. Is it what? 8:33. Better not be 8:33. Yeah. Okay, right. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I'm not blaming Paul. It's just that I said, Paul said, right, we're going live in a minute. And I said, oh, on my, what's this thing called? iPad. It was only 7:56. He went, no, 7:58 and a half. And I was like, oh, okay. Anyway, we've got a fantastic show lined up for you today. Early bird, early bird, early bird. Now, this, you need this for, or you might need this for hour 11. But also, this sells incredibly well. Now, I know it's boring to look at. Looks like an old dish rag, doesn't it? But look, it is Styleville Fix. Half a metre, you're saving a pound. It's normally £6.99. Brilliant for bag making, brilliant for, got a review already. Oh, a FIFO, not a. Very useful to keep to hand, especially for bag making. What did I just say? I said exact same set. Sarah, I didn't see where she was. Sarah. When we make these, Jude's in and we're making these at 11. Brilliant for that. But also, like you say, for bag making. Now, let me put my glass on. It's one side fixable, this, isn't it? Yep, this is the iron it on, one side fusible. It's fantastic, absolutely fantastic. And this is the piece you get. So it's half a metre, but it's not very wide. It's 72 centimetres wide. So this is your half a metre. That's exactly what you get. What's the matter? Oh, somebody messed with your screens, Paul. Oh, okay. Jenny says good morning from the beautiful Isle of Wight. Paula says good morning. Oh, there you go. You see, we were early, weren't we? Princess says morning, gorgeous man. Barbara says morning, John. Mary Jane says morning, John and team. Looking forward to the show. You and Wendy had me in stitches yesterday. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Emily says, hang on. Morning, John. Lovely morning. Like the shirt. This is ancient, this shirt. It's so old, I can't tell you. Sheila says, good morning. Morning, darling John and crew, says Sue. Lovely morning here in, I don't know if they say that, Roster. Do you say that as Roster? Gorgeous sunshine, but still chilly. Looking forward to the Seminole cushion. Oh, they're lovely, aren't they? Anne says, morning, John, Paul and crew. Great to have Paul back, says Anne. Oh, I was going to say, how do you know Paul's back? Of course, I've mentioned him already. He's back. Cousin Susan says, John and co, have a lovely sunny day. Sue says, good morning all. Loads of you there. Now, make sure you check out on this. Now, remember, if you buy multiples, it doesn't come joined together. It comes, if you buy three, you'll get three pieces like this. But once you paid your P&P, that's it, done for the day. Done for the day, no matter if you buy a bundle of fabric, whether you buy the cushion pattern, whether you buy the pattern for the anything, and sewing, like Yarn Lane as well. It's your P&P, paid for. And Yarn Lane's on, I'll tell you about that, but Yarn Lane's on pre-order already because it's going to be a busy day. Anna, Nikki, Provi, Doski. That's not right. Somebody sent me yesterday how to say it properly, the phonetic way to say it. I'll get it right later. I'll get it right. Oh, yeah, so like Paul's left his hay fever pills on the kitchen counter. I've left my big red bottle on my kitchen counter, not on Paul's kitchen counter. Were you? Yeah, oh, now you have to feel for Kat, right? Kat's producing today. She should be in Australia today because one of her best friends is getting married today. And so she's just watched it live on her phone and everything. But I remember months and months and months ago, she and Jeremy's her brother, they were supposed to go together. Was Liam going as well? Oh, no, the boyfriend wasn't going. Oh, you couldn't leave him in the house on his own, the new house on his own. Anyway, they said a few months ago, oh yeah, we've still got our tickets booked for April. And we're all like, oh, you'll be fine by then. Oh, we'll be back to normal by then. Little did we know. Morning, Jackie Lewis. How are you, my lovely? What a glorious sunny day in Suffolk. Made even more glorious by seeing you, John Scott. Thank you. Lady K. Todd says, morning all. Have a great show. Donna says, morning and team. John and team. Morning, John. Out of sunny Silverstone. Lovely shirt, says Claire. Jilly says, morning, John. Join the peace before the six grandchildren wake up. Oh, my goodness. Glennon says, good morning, John and team. Trisha Ann says, good morning all. Looking forward to the shows because, John, you are very funny. Thank you, Trisha. Oh, God, I messed you on my bottom from Jane. I have to read this over here, I'm afraid. Morning, John and team, from a very cold but sunny Farnham. Have a good day. Oh, Jane with a Y. posh. Susan says, good morning, John and crew. Got my coffee, ready to enjoy the show. Pam Minnie Harney says, good morning all. What a beautiful sunny day. Diane says, good morning, lovely John and the team. Looking forward to the programme. Oh, Jackie feels better for seeing me. How's Dave, Jackie? How is he? Dave's not been well. Anyway, have you all bought this? I'm not moving on until you've all bought it. Message on my bottom. Morning, John. Just received a scrap bag. Not one piece under a fat quarter. From boiled wool to jersey. Brilliant value from Barbara. Thank you, Barbara. Glad to hear it. Now, if you're not happy with it, you know you can always send it back. I mean, Barbara's obviously happy with it. But if you open yours, you think, oh, I didn't. I think on the whole, they're brilliant. But if you're not 100% happy, just let us know. Just let us know. And I don't know if we can do it again at the moment, but we'll sort it out for you. Oh yeah, a big, big box of scraps went over yesterday. Kat sent them over yesterday. Sue says, morning, lovely John. Sunny in Tamworth. Oh, we were just talking about Tamworth. That's where Jeremy, Joe and Kat's mum and dad live, near there. What? She's going to the Fig and Olive in Tamworth tomorrow, is Kat. Whatever that is. Love the colours of your shirt, says Sue. Thank you very much indeed. What's the matter, Paul? It is a problem. Restaurant next to a garden centre. She's going to be sitting outside. I tell you what, the Four Alls yesterday, where I go over the bridge over the village next to me, it was packed outside. Absolutely packed it was yesterday. All outside, obviously. Oh, now, Paul, yesterday there was an issue with one of these cameras because somebody messaged in saying, can I see your belt buckle? And I went like that to show my belt buckle, right? And we could, and so the picture was just me just standing like that. Right, that's early bird done. Now, that needs to go back into the 11 o'clock clock trolley. oh, no, before you go on, no, panel of the week. Panel of the week, right. Now, this is a special price, right. Now, every Tuesday, listen, Paul, I'll tell you. Every Tuesday morning, we launch a panel of the week, right. It's a special price for the week. Then after the week is up, the price goes up. The price goes up. So I've got this week, because it was, did you know it was National Pet Week this week, Paul? No, so they were pets. So I'm going to start with the cats. Now, it's not been made from pets. Oh, now, dogs. Dogs have been winning completely all week. So we've got how many days? Now, is it available? Oh, does it not go out on a Monday then? Oh, so it runs, we stop, what? Well, no, because she did it on a Tuesday. She launched it this week, didn't she? So it's not, right, okay, only goes to a Sunday. It's not on a Monday. I suppose that's because she has panel of the month or whatever. What's the matter, Paul? Which one? That one. That one. He's sleeping. Oh, now he's having a cat nap, Paul. Oh, now I've got more information. I didn't have this yesterday. So tomorrow night at midnight, this goes up to $14.99. Should I just remember that? $9.99. So what happens is we launch it on a Tuesday. We give you a quick glimpse of it every day until Sunday. Then on Monday's nothing. And then Tuesday, I'm in on Tuesday, I launch the next one. Now, I haven't seen it. I've been told about the next one. Oh, yeah, sorry. I forgot about that because I was trying to get the cat's one. Because dogs is winning, you see. So I'll put that there ready for tomorrow. I can't believe it. Really. I don't agree with you. No, I've seen a pink poodle. Kat says she loves the way that they're cartoony, they're not trying to be real. Have a look. $9.99, that's what we've got tomorrow night. Yeah, it won't be, they'll have forgotten. I can't find my comb either this morning. Judy says, good morning, everyone. Claire says, yes, Claire, I know, sorry. I don't know why, but I'm very, you know when you keep dribbling? I don't know what it is. I've got to. Is it my age? Thanks, Paul. I'm just kind of, you know, there's too much. And we discovered yesterday I'm doing 6 days in a row, the week after next. And every weekend for the whole of April and the whole of May. Yep. Yeah, when's Vic's coming back? Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to fold that away. While I fold that away, let's have a look at tomorrow's menu. What's the matter, Paul? Oh, today's... I just said it, didn't I? Tomorrow's menu. Let's have a look at today's menu then. Right now, this fabric is already selling. It's one of Kat's favourite. It's one of Kat's favourite collections we've ever had. It's called the Whimsy Daisical fabric. Then at 9 o'clock, now yesterday the menu did say that Victoria Carrington was in. She's not. It's Victoria Carrington Seminole Cushions with Jude Edmondson. I've not met Jude before. Today's the first day I've met Jude. So do you want to have a look at those cushions? Please, little Paul. There you go. That's one of them. We've got new colourways. That's one. And that's the other. Lovely, aren't they? Beautiful, gorgeous designs as well. So that's at 9 o'clock. Then at 10 o'clock, we've got Kaffe Fassett fabrics. Now, Kat and I launched those this week, right? And what happened was most of them sold out. We couldn't get any more in. But what did happen was in 1 hour, we had bundles that didn't all sell out. So we've been able to disband them. And so we got bundles and we've got fabrics and gorgeousness for those you missed out earlier on in the week. The blue bundle is not available, but we can create it from 0.5 meters of fabric, I'm sure. At 11 o'clock, we have got floral fabric baskets. There they are. Nice, beautiful. Oh, there's the flower. There's the butterfly. I love that fabric in there. It's beautiful, isn't it? I think the orange one in the middle would be a skirt from West Side Story. Anyway, then at 12 o'clock, we all run down the road to Yarn Lane Studio. We are doing a crochet along with Anna Nikki Pinovitz. So I think that was right, wasn't it? There are three ways you can get in touch. The first way you can get in touch is, there's something missing. Oh yeah, somebody's moved the plant. No, it's fine, I don't mind, but it's just weird, isn't it? What was the, did we have mannequins yesterday? No, we had Wendy Orlando, she fills the space, doesn't she? Anyway, you can email studio@sewingstreet.com, she'll be watching. Studio@sewingstreet.com. Yeah, studio@sewingstreet.com. That's an email. They're the ones that Kat reads out down my ears. You can also send a message on Facebook Live. Let's see if I've got any more messages. Morning, John Scott, says Louise. Thank you. And then the other way you can send a message is, do you know what's happened? My pants have come a bit high at the back and there's a scratchy label in the back and it's kind of making... I hate them. And I always wear the same... I'm not going to talk about pants. No. The same design of pants in the same colour every day. And they've all got... Go to the website, right? And click on Watch the Show Live. When you get there, you'll see me at the top there. Then to the right-hand side, there's a little square where you can write your message. When you send that one in, you can... they're the white boxes that come on my bottom. Okay, now, if you scroll down... you'll see there's today's early bird. Obviously, it doesn't come on. Oh, we've already played some fabric through, I noticed. So we have today's show deals, which is normally, there's today's show deals. That's normally or everything as we have shown it, you will see it there. So you can pop it in your basket from there. However, if you've got to pop out later and you're thinking, what's John got on the show? You can go to pre-order, click on that. Now, look. Now, those fabrics, I haven't got those fabrics. I don't think the pictures... Oh, there, I've got those. Yeah, got those. Oh, that's the one Jude picked as well, Paul. Some of those pictures are a picture. Oh, mega bundle. Anyway, keep going. So that's the first hour. Then we've got the Seminole cushions. We've got... Oh, and the pattern on its own as well as the bundles, just so you know. So there's four different bundles, plus... the one's a bit Christmassy. Plus... and we're not talking about Christmas. Yeah. Then we get to Kaffe. There's the Kaffe. Oh, Paul, it's amazing. You're going to love it. The book. We've got more of the book in stock. And you don't have to wait now. It'll be ready to be sent straight out to you with that one. And it's less than it should be. Isn't it? Oh, something sold out already. Oh, the feathers look sold out already. Got to be on it with Kaffe. Okay. Oh, and there's my favourite one. There's some of my favourite one left. Oh, that's because we disbanded the bundles, of course, yeah. So a lot of those sold out during the week. Anyway, then we move on to the bags. Oh, that button's not a giant button. That's not a giant button, that one. And then that's it. That's it for Sewing Street. If you go over to Yarn Lane, we'll show you quickly Yarn Lane. We're not supposed to do this, but we'll show you. Do exactly the same thing. Watch live. You can see everything. Now, look, we're doing a quilt, a crochet along with Anna. And what it is the pattern is completely for free. Completely for free, isn't it, the pattern? Right? So we're selling the bundle of yarn to make it with. And then each time Anna comes on, we will do another block. I think it's fantastic, and you can crochet along with us. Right, shall we make a start? I don't think I've got anything else to tell you, have I? Oh, Stuart, morning. Great lineup today, by the looks of things. Alison Marion said, I've told Ian and Hayley we should be making boxes. Boxers. No, we're not. Oh, no, when we were sewing quarter, we weren't allowed to do underwear for some reason. It came from even higher. Oh, Wendy Orlando, I told you she'd be in, didn't I? Yes, I'm here busy sewing, making the most gorgeous project. Oh, you should always cut the labels out of your pants. Don't want a scratchy doodah. Now Marcia's created a new person. She said, morning, John Scott, Paul and Katie. Just back for a walk on the beach with hubby. Very sunny already in Southport. Oh, very nice. I don't know who Katie is though. Oh, Kat, it's re-whatsited itself, hasn't it? What's it do? Spell checky thing. And Carol says, good morning. And Susan says she misses being by the sea. I moved to Derbyshire from Norfolk. Well, mega bundle time. Now, you get all of this. 8.5 metres with 0.5 metre for free. There is more up here. You'll have to pull out a little bit, Paul, I'm afraid. There we go. Aren't they beautiful? They're fresh, they're gorgeous, they're bright. Oh, and it's on split pay. So not only are you getting 0.5 metre for free, you can also buy it on split pay if you want to. I know. Now, no, you won't get, no. Kat said, if I do split pay, you get it all? Like, so what happens? Your payment will be taken at midnight. Your first payment will be taken at midnight tonight. And then it'll go in the process of being sent to you. So it should be there this week. We're up to date. Are we up to date with deliveries? Nobody's given us an update, have they? I'm having my haircut on Monday. I can't wait. Oh, I can't wait, I tell you. Yeah, no, mullet's about, but not for me. Right, okay. So if you don't have... Now, the other thing is you don't have to take split pay if you don't want to. That's your choice. So when you come to pay, it'll give you the choice. It's up there, isn't it? No, there. There's a box comes up. It says, do you want split pay? You click on there. You don't pay any interest whatsoever. It's literally the price cut in half. That's it. No interest. And you only pay the one P&P, obviously. So if you already bought the early bird, your P&P is done for. But if you haven't bought the early bird, the first payment of $59.92 will then add on. You have to add on your $3.95 postage packaging. But as Kat was just saying, you get it straight away, the whole lot. You don't get half of it now and half of it when you pay the second instalment. You just get it all now. And what you get is you get 0.5 metre of every single fabric. They're all cut. So if you buy two, you won't get a metre of each fabric. You'll get 2.5 metres of each fabric. But aren't they fresh and bright? They're very painterly, these, aren't they? Very like watercolory, landscape artist of the lady who won the landscape artist of the year. She would have done something like that, wouldn't she? She painted landscapes. But in the landscapes, there would be something like unusual, like a monkey reading a newspaper. What did they paint? It wasn't a gherkin, I don't think it was the final, was it? I can't remember, they were brilliant. I love all those. I love the ones that you do faces. Portrait. Oh, they're brilliant, Paul. Okay, now Gerardine's making people up now as well. Hello, John, Victoria, and everybody. What gorgeous fabric. Victoria's not in today. Jude's in today. We're making Victoria Carrington's cushions. You're everybody today, Paul. You're just everybody today, Paul. Right, where's what? Okay, these are flying out. I've got fewer than 15. It's only 20 past eight on a Saturday morning. I was convinced it was Sunday this morning as I drove in. Absolutely convinced. Right, now, I've got them in bundles, right? Now, you might be wondering why I've got them on the table like that, right? Because I've got them in bundles. So I've got an orange and pink bundle. I've got a blue and pink bundle. I've got a blue and green bundle. And I've got a green bundle. So if you don't want the whole lot... Oh, now I also need to tell you, I've got all of them by the half metre as well. So if you're thinking, oh, I only want the pink spot one, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. But I just need to do your bundles first. Right. Let's start with the pink bundle first then. So that's this one. So, Whimsy Daisical pink fabric bundle. 3 metres. You get 6 fabrics here. So you get the spot, the little spot. That's nice, isn't it? Lovely. Paul, what number's written on there? Then you've got the big dot. You see, that one looks a bit cave-ish to me. And then this one here is like the bricks. Then you've got the baby flowers. Then you've got the big flowers. And then you've got the butterflies. So you get 3 metres of fabric, 6 pieces of fabric in total, each half a metre. Oh, Gerardine says, don't know what's happening to me recently. Must have banged my head. I know, Gerardine, that's the third. Is that the third day you've messaged him with funny messages? Amanda says, good morning, everyone. It's beautiful here in Loddington. Loving your shirt, John. Thank you. Carol says, love the fabric. Sad I can't get anything. Why not, Carol? Why not? Wendy says, morning, sunny in Potton. Great to see you this morning. Mary says, morning, John. Happy I get to watch you on my birthday. Mary, happy birthday. We're not allowed to sing it. We're not allowed to sing it. Yeah. So £44.49. Then what colour are we going to next? Blue or green? We'll go to blue now. So that one goes there. So this is blue. This is a 2 metre bundle. So in this one, oh, it's not, I like this one. Is it my favourite? Is it though? Right, so you get... Oh, what's the matter? Okay, do not trust the pictures on the website. Trust me, I'm a fashion guru. Trust me, I'm a fabric. No, it has to be an F, wouldn't it? F. Fat what, Paul? Anyway, so you get the blue, a fabric fashionista. Dot, you get the blue brick, that's lovely, isn't it? Then you get the blue flowers, which also is gorgeous. Then you get the butterflies blue on green. Oh yeah, ignore the pictures on the website, they're wrong. They're wrong. This is definitely the right one in the description, isn't it? Yeah. This is what you'll get if you order the blue one. Lots of those in baskets. Well, I'm not surprised. £29.49 for 2 metres. They're lovely, aren't they? Oh, Carol's got no money. Oh, Carol. Jane says, morning, John. Loving the show and your shirt. Thank you. What'd you say, Cap? Oh, yes. The bags that come up later were lovely in this. The lining of the bags were lovely in these, wouldn't they? Okay, so that's the blue. My well-laid plans have gone a bit awry here. There we go. Green next. No, green, here we go. At least the trolleys arrived yesterday. We didn't have to come in this morning and unpack trolleys. Paul, they didn't arrive the day before. So when we came in yesterday morning, we had to unpack all the trolleys. Yeah, So Emma and I were here really early, unpacking and doing the trolleys. Hannah sauntered in, it's about 20 past, eating a Greg sausage roll. Anyway, she looked nice. There we go. So this is the green one. So green, I think this might be, this or the blue are my favourite. So you got the green, gorgeous green dot. Then, I love that. They do look like limes on a pink tablecloth, don't they? Then you've got the bricks. And then you've got your lovely pink flowers on green. That's beautiful, that one, isn't it? Oh, there you go. This is Stuart's favourite. Green and... He's put purple. I'd call it magenta rather than purple. Oh, that one does look a bit purpley on my telly. Morning, John. Lovely but frosty day in South Devon. Off to play bowls. I don't think it is Free Spirits Church. Let's have a look. No, it's Blank Quilting Whimsy Daisical. Right, finally, we've got the orange bundle. Cat loves the orange and pink. Here you go. I'm just to the side here. Here you go. This one's just 1.5 meters, this one. It's just, it's not that there. Oh. Sue says, I haven't got any money either. Doesn't seem to affect my willpower. I keep telling myself, no pockets in a shroud. Well, true, true. That means you can't take it with you. Yeah. And also, things happen. If this pandemic's taught us anything, is it? It's, you've just got to enjoy every minute. Who thought a year ago that I wouldn't, you know, I see you, obviously, but, you know, I haven't seen anyone. Nobody's been to my house. You know, it's kind of like a bit of a lonely old time, isn't it? Makes you realise that you've got to take, you know, enjoy every day, basically. I'm not going to give a lecture. Here we go. So you get pink flowers, big pink, pink and orange flowers, and then pink and pink and, I keep wanting to say vanilla. I don't mean vanilla. Pink and orange butterflies. There you go. It's only day two as well. No, you weren't in yesterday. Yeah, but when you have a new house, you like to clean the house, don't you? Right, let's start right now. Here we go. So that lives there like that, and that lives there like that. Can I try to show you the mega bundle again, just in case you did want the whole mega? Now you've seen the fabrics, you wanted the mega bundle. This is the mega bundle. Got the phone number in there, look. Okay, that's right. I don't know these things. Right, we're going to start with butterflies. Are we likely to go back to... Oh, Dave's watching. Hello, Dave. Dave's in hospital. He's watching in hospital. And then Shelley says, good morning, we're having a cup of tea in bed. You got your pyjamas on. Let me have a look. Oh, Clint. Right, okay, are we going to go back to bundles? Okay. Right, so I'm doing butterflies first, just to say. Right, hang on, let me move these out of the way so we can have a nice space. Oh, Cat! Don't buy this yet, don't buy this. I'll just put the code out for Cat. KLUI28. I have pink background. Blimey, oh, that all the way over there? Crikey. Okay, right, I'm with you. Right, so we're doing butterflies first. These are three different colours. I've got two butterflies. We're going to do blue background. Yeah. I think they're making these stickers less sticky because we have had so many issues. So this is 7.49 for half metre, 100% cotton. Machine washable. The lovely little green antennae on there. Oh, Paul thought they were strawberries. That's Cat, because Cat's sitting there. Oh, Stuart's off to his shop. Let's hope he has a busy day today. He had the busiest day ever on the first day back. So you said, just thought, I want to be wrapped in my Liberty stash, Egyptian mummy style. Okay, Sue, this is a bit worrying. Right, okay, let me just turn that one over. Oh, got a message, is it Teresa and Luna? On the bottom of the screen, saying, good morning, John, from Terry and I in sunny South London. Looking forward to spending the morning with you. Sloppy kisses from Luna. Luna. Squirrels! Squirrels, Luna! For those of you who don't know, Luna's a dog. And Luna, if I do that, she runs from the... I'm thinking Luna's a girl, isn't it? Runs from the telly to the window, to the window, to the telly, like that, going, where are the squirrels? Where are the squirrels? Where are the squirrels? Anyway, 7.49 for half metre. Beautiful. You You get name tags on stickers and they keep coming off in the wash. Oh, Carol. Yeah, the thing is though, what we have to do is when we have to pack up, I have to tell you all the secrets now. We all have to pack up after the show and we have to take the sticker off the fabric, put it on the bag. Even me. I love it. That's the best bit of the day. I love packing fabric away. You thought what, Paul? No. No. Okay. That's a definite no, Paul. Green. This should chuck. Now, we're in the half metre. When you buy a half metre, like if you want 4 metres to make some curtains or a kiddie's bedroom or a dress or some cushions or some bedding or something like that. No, Paul. Oh, let me turn it over because I want the sticky label. No, Paul, you know I love working with you. Oh, he's on one today. Oh, now hang on, this one's got the green antennae on a green background. Yeah, it's like you're in Stratford-upon-Avon and you're on one of those, you're on the big wheel in Stratford-upon-Avon. You look down into the butterfly house because we've got a butterfly museum in Stratford-upon-Avon. And you look down and you see the butterflies fluttering around the grass and all the green plants. Trudy says, morning, John and crew. You're looking very flower power this morning. Thank you. Right, that's the green one. Now I've got it with the pink background with the orange. Now what's this one going to be? If the other one was butterflies in the sky and that one was looking down at butterflies. Oh, this is, we've lost a label yesterday. So Hannah, this is Hannah's. Hannah said, I'll make a new label for it. There's the label for this one. No, it's butterflies before a storm. You know, in the sky sometimes goes that pinky colour. Oh, Paul says he'd love a shirt made out of this. Oh, Paul, we had some fabric yesterday and every one would have been fabulous shirts for you. Dan Morris fabrics, they were lovely. They were inspired by batiks, but they were digital print. Maybe it's the same band. Hello, little Paul. I thought you'd left, couldn't keep away from Sue. Little Paul's freelance, so he comes in. He didn't leave. Very bright, says Susan. Oh no, are they Susan? I didn't know if we were supposed to stay. I did ask. I haven't got a black shirt. We are doing the minute silence at 3 o'clock. Not that we'll be here, but you know. Okay, moving on. I've got big flowers next. Right, there you go. So I've got 3 different colours in this one. Oh, they're lovely, aren't they? Margaret, it's me and Paul and Kat today. Oh, she's going shopping. Bernadette says, I just tried to knit after 20 years. Well, 2 mittens, firstborn size. Well done for me, both the same. Next, booties, newborn. Oh, that's a long message. I'll read all that later for you. Starting with the blue. This is lovely and fresh, isn't it? 7.49 for half a metre, remember? Oh, that is pretty, isn't it? I'll put my hand in so you can see how big those flowers are. Wouldn't that be lovely? I don't know what I'd make out of that one, though. Holiday shirt. Nice big bag to take to the beach when you're allowed to go to the beach. Well, you're allowed to go to the beach now, aren't you? But you just cut. Don't you have to wear your mask on the beach, though? Oh, I'm confused by what we're supposed to and not supposed to be doing. $7.49 for half a metre. Crazy Lorraine's in. Loving these fabrics, John. So pretty, thank you. Orange next. Well, I did ask. Which one are you doing first, orange? $7.49. Beautiful, isn't it? It's, what they've done is it looks like they've drawn the flowers, done the highlights, then just splodged the background around the space, isn't it? A parasol for your garden. They're not the easiest things to make. Then it says, good morning, John and team. I swear your hair has grown inches in the last few days. Never known the hair, must know the hairdresser beckons. Do you know what? Yesterday I thought exactly the same. It's suddenly gone like right over my ear, hasn't it? Paul doesn't have that problem, he says. Oh, got a message from M. What, from James Bond M? Like Judi Dench M? MI6 isn't in Herefordshire now. Morning, John. What plain colour would you recommend to go with the whimsical collection? Thank you. Have a lovely day. Now, it's funny you should ask that, Em. Well, I'll do these. They're all individual. Look, I've got all of these. What I might do is let me finish doing the whimsical fabrics, then we'll go through the planes to go with. Actually, do you know what? Kat's had a very good idea as well. I think these are called mixers, aren't they? Right, but they're splodgy. No, this is the wrong green. Don't buy that green to go with that. But because it's got splodgy in the background, it might work, you see. That green's not right. We won't be doing that green. No, that's not right. Well, actually, let me just take all these away because I don't think any of these are going to work. No. No, I'm going to put them on others around me. Right, okay, we'll come back to that. I will let you know, M. Shaken, not stirred. Oh, have you not? I'm a bit ahead of myself, sorry. Oh, no, pink and orange. I always said, no, pink and orange looks gorgeous. Who said that? I've always struggled to see how pink and orange... No, now, you see, I always say... If Mother Nature puts two colours together, then it must be all right, mustn't it? Because people say blue and green, red and green, all that, never be seen. Look at the bushes. Look at holly bushes. Look at that lovely... What's that one with called with the big blue... there's a bush that grows like a hedge and it's got big blue... But pink and orange, fuchsias. You only have to look at a fuchsia, don't you? Yeah, this isn't fuchsia though, Paul. Next, right, do I want pattern? I'm going to little flowers now. Oh, look. Did that just come off that one? What was that last one? Did it finish 81? What's going on? Oh, single figures on the mega bundle. Single figures on the mega bundle now. Okay, so now I'm doing little flowers. So I've got little flowers in pink and green and orange. This is the last of the orange and pink ones. There you go. Start of the orange one. Oh, that's nice. That's very fresh, isn't it? But I'm kind of seeing outdoor... When the summer comes, like cushions and coasters and placemats and things like that with this one for some reason. £7.49 for half a metre. 100% cotton, machine washable, quilting weight. Gorgeous. Next is the green one. I'm not surprised this one's popular. I like this one. Mind you what? Oh, that's funny, because some of the fabric that Wendy Orlando had yesterday, she kept saying, oh, it reminds me of fruit salad chewy sweets. Oh, did Alice Marion put a picture of... I don't know what Kat's talking about now. £7.49. Then I've got the pink and blue. Beautiful. Oh, I can announce it now. I couldn't announce it. Vix is going home with the baby. Vix and Kieran are going home with Maisie now, this morning. They're on their way home now. We knew, but I didn't want to be the... It's not my place to obviously make announcements, but she put it on Facebook now, so it's fine. Aww. That's when it really kicks in, isn't it? Like, she's going to be at home with a baby. It's all very well being, oh, I'm in a noisy hospital and I want to go home. Imagine now. She'll be brilliant. Poached eggs on toast for breakfast on Sewing Street.
Oh,
no. I read that wrong, sorry. Poached eggs on toast for breakfast and John on Sewing Street. I love poached eggs on toast. When I worked at Theatre Clwyd, we had a little upstairs in the green room. There were like, Ron used to cook food for everybody. And every day I'd go, I'm going to have something different today. I'm going to have something different. Poached eggs on toast, please, Ron. Every day for a year. I was there for a year with brown sauce. Beautiful. Oh, I love poached eggs. Right, okay, now I'm doing the bricks. These are nice, aren't they? Cat thinks these are very Kaffe as well. Kaffe, essence of Kaffe. Got them in pink, the green, and the blue. It's not Hannah today, Derek. It's Kat today. What amazing fabrics. Great flamboyant shirts. Fantastic picture of Maisie in the car seat. Oh, I can't see it yet. I can't see it. Do pink first. Oh, this is nice. Isn't that lovely? I love that. That's really bold. Oh, now, what you might not be able to see at home is there's a green dot in between each one. Oh, Kat's just showing me the picture of Maisie in the car going home. She's waving and everything. Well, of course she is. They're two parents, two showbiz parents. Of course she is. I wonder if her first words won't be like mama or papa. They'll be like, mamma mia, you know, something from a musical, won't it? It'll be ABBA, definitely ABBA. She was singing ABBA in the late stages of labour. Her and the midwives were singing ABBA in the late stages. Okay, that's the pink one. Oh, good morning, Kat. There you go. Kate says, if you could go back to one point in time in your fabulous career, what would it be? Well, I'm supposed to say now, I suppose, on time. Do you know what? The happiest, I mean, I'm sounds like I'm doing a memorial now, isn't it? But I have loved all my career, but my favourite time, working in theatre. You cannot beat working in live theatre. Sadly, it pays no money. And I couldn't afford to live, but... getting carried away this one. Which colour would you like to see next? I was just reaching for the blue one. Because Kat works in live theatre as well. There's nothing like working in live theatre. It's just amazing. So I love that, but you're scraping your pennies together for a gin and tonic on a Wednesday night. You got paid what? Oh, what were you doing? Where? Oh, yeah. When you're on a big show like that, she was on Gary Barlow's The Band. She got paid. No. Like, I remember I worked in regional reps. I was at Theatre Clwyd, Mercury Theatre Colchester, Stoke, and York. And when you work in that kind of theatre, you got paid. No, it was the Victoria, the old Vic. Didn't they build a new one in Stoke? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, no. Remember, Kat, I was there before your mum and dad were even married. You know what I mean? But anyway, it is fantastic. But then you see, I love working on major movies as well. You know, kind of, they're all, everything has its pluses and minuses, isn't it? And of course, working with Little Paul, that's up there as well. But also, look at the different colour blues. Look how many blues are in there. Yeah, look, they've all been individually painted or stamped. Oh, Paul's seeing aquariums. I'm seeing a swimming pool floor. Yeah, there you go. We got there in the end. Oh, this one's called Daisy Chain. I didn't realise they had names. Oh, sorry, I've not been reading out the names. I did a Jamaica recently. I did one. They just call me when nobody else will do it. It was bank holiday weekend or something like that. £7.49 for half a metre. It is big spots next. Oh, there's only two. Oh, now there's only two colourways of the big spots, Kat. Blue and pink, or pink and green. This is Stuart's favourite. Oh, and Jude. Yeah, no, but Stuart's messaging, didn't say it was his favourite as well. Neck and neck in pre-sales. This is nice, isn't it? Lovely, isn't it? Wrong colours for Mr. Blobby. Yeah. What about the pot? Who was it on the telly? There was a newsreader recently, or somebody had, I think it was Kate Garraway, had a top, no, it wasn't Kate Garraway, had a top on, and everyone messaged, it was pink and yellow, and everyone's saying, oh, she's got Mr. Blobby top on, and she was not happy. It wasn't Kate Garraway, it was somebody else, I think. Beautiful. I'll put my hand in so you see the size of spots. And then the green one. Now, Paul, you've got 5 hours to go before you can go home. Beautiful. Then I've got the small dots. The small dots. Yeah, last print now. Imagine being in Australia, you wouldn't be able to do it, would you? Look, aren't they lovely? No, but Kat was supposed to be in Australia this week, wasn't she? Pink first. Now, I love this because the background's blotch. Oh, yes. Oh, this is what, Kat, would you buy this and make the bags that we're doing in the 11 o'clock hour, Kat would use this fabric for. Margaret says, morning, John, how big is your shirt collection? Nice one this morning. This one's ancient. This one's so old, Margaret. And I gave, before lockdown, I think I gave about 150 away to charity shop. I know. Are they open yet? I've got so much stuff for the charity shop. Because this time last year, I had my big clear out, didn't I? Thinking, well, they'll be open in 3 weeks. We're only going to lockdown for 3 weeks, they said, didn't they? Green or blue? Yeah, you can mix and match. And Kat loves this because I'll show you again. I'll mix and match them all in a second. But polka dot, this one's called. Polka dot. Looks like what, Paul? Yeah, 72. That's because it always is 72. Finally, of this collezione, we've got the blue. This is very popular on pre-order. Remember, you're buying it now by the half meter. Oh, that's nice. I'm saying it again. Lots of people just buying half meters, their favorite. Sue says, yes, all the shops are open, John. I've got loads to send to. Oh, I'll do that. When have I got a day off? Oh, Monday, but I'm fully booked on Monday. Got one day off. Right, that was the whole collection. Let me get the whole lot out again for you soon. If you just want half a metre of each with half a metre for free, then you can get the mega bundle. Paul's going to show you still. Okay, I'm going to get them all out because I'm going to do the matching colour, you know, the complementary colours now. loads beautiful, aren't they? So if you want that, who's that was I? Okay, I'll get it now. I'm coming to the butterfly now. Yeah, here we go. Right, so Sue wants to see the blue butterfly. Well, I've got two butterflies. Does she want to see the blue-green or does she want to see the blue-pink? Sue, which one of those do you want me to waft and I'll do it for you? Right, okay, so that's the whole collection there. So like Kat's saying, you could pick any two of those if you only wanted two and they'd all go together beautifully. This is the mega bundle. So you're getting half meter free and you're getting the option of split pay. Oh, would you? I wouldn't put ivory or white with it. Well, I'll have a look now as we go through the simple colours. Do you want to see the blue-green? Okay, so what was the question about it? Oh, on the website it looks different. So the background, I just explained to you, it's definitely lime green and a kind of grass green. And then the butterflies are definitely blue with blue dots and their antennae are a darker lime green. Claire, what's the name of the Scandi-style dressmaking book? I can't find it on the website. And morning, John, love your shirt. I have some Tilda fabric, very similar. Our local charity shop is asking you to take items to their warehouse, not the shops. Oh, this is interesting to know. There, you see. That was from Lintuit. Right, okay, and the other one. What is the, it's Jotty, what's the name of the Scandinavian dress book, Kat? Oh, Alison Marion, are you watching? Can you tell me the name of that lovely Scandinavian dress book? I'll just show you the blue one in case it was the blue one you wanted to see. There's the blue one with the pink butterflies. No, it's called, it's a very simple, she's standing in a barn on the front in a shift dress. Alison Marion's made everything in the book and I think she's called Gianni Gelotti or something like that. No, the Sewing Bee book sold out yesterday. Sue, the Sewing Bee book, was it yesterday or the day before? Day before. Right, let me just explain about the Sewing Bee book. It's not got pictures of the contestants in, it's not got patterns in. It's a techniques book. So what they've done is from all the old books, they've taken all the techniques like how to do a full bust adjustment, how to do a zip, how to do this, how to do that. All are sold out. Wendy had it on 2 days ago and it sold out, Right, okay, let's do some colours that might go with, right? So this one looks beautiful with all of them, doesn't it? Can you go a little bit further up, Paul? It's called Everyday Style, is it? Oh, there it is, Alison Marion. So now, can you look on the website to see where it is? Because somebody can't find it. Claire can't find it. Lotta Jan's daughter, Everyday Style. Thank you, Alison Marion. So this is $3.49. Say that again. Yeah, bright pink, this is called. We're just seeing if we've got it, because Claire can't find it on the website, that's all. Oh, it's sold out. It's sold out, I'm afraid, Claire. Not the pink, but the book that Claire wanted. No, I just want you to see all that, you see, so it goes with all of the colours, see. I think a lot of these are good. Let me just look at this one. This one's like a teal, jade even. See, it's different, but it goes. I think I might use that as my background of my quilt. So that one's jade. I've got to run through these quite quickly now because I'm about to run out of time. Because Jude, that was jade, but Jude's waiting to come on. This one here is lime. It's nice. I don't think I'd use it, but it's nice. Yeah, exactly. But no, exactly. They're all by the half metre. Oh, loads. Honor travels in the motorhome. Jeff's driving, me watching, she says. Oh, the people next door to me have got a great big motorhome pulled up in their drive. I don't know how they got out of it without walking over my garden. Right, this one. Candy. Now, I never understand why that one's called candy. I wouldn't buy sweets that were blue, would you? Moving on. Now I've got purple. It might not be called purple. Imperial, that's a lovely, wouldn't put that with this, but it's a lovely fabric, so I'll still put it through. Oh, you, Kat likes it with this collection. I think it's a bit too on the heavy side, personally. Next is Peacock. That works. Hang on, Sue's watching from the beach at the end of the road. Oh, how lovely. Oh, and Sue's on the M6. You're all watching while you're on the move. And then Ange. Isn't it lovely that you can all go traveling and watching me on the move? Beautiful, isn't it? Right, that's me. Haven't got anything else to do. I've got to go. Love to Sew home accessories, 60 stunning accessories to make for you and your home. So yeah, this is from Search Press. What they've done is Search Press have taken all their favorite designers. I think there's some Debbie Shaw in here actually. And they've taken all their favorite designers and then put their favorite projects. The templates are all at the back there. So you've got glasses case. Does it say who's done them? Oh no. Oh, it doesn't give a name to the author. Oh, I bet they're not happy about that. Pin cushions, jewellery boards, tape measure cover, hot water bottle cover, bolster pillow. We're going to summer, why do you need a hot water bottle? Tidy candy, table runner, bread basket, craft cardy, strawberry makeup bag. How many projects are in here? 50. 50 projects for $10.99. Oh, 60? Where did I get 50 from? Oh, no, I looked here. 50 Search Press. It must be Search Press's 50th year birthday. 60. Even better. No, I wouldn't break that down into price per pattern. She's going to anyway. 18p a project. And it comes in a lovely book. And you get the templates as well. Okay, we're going for a break now. Okay, how many mega bundles are left then? Let's just run the graphics through very quickly. Oh, six. Sure. Now, how come you can look that up when the graphics aren't in, but Hannah can't? Okay. And how many are in baskets? So please be careful. At $119.84, split pay of $59.92, just two payments. But how many say six? Six left. Right, now Jude's up. I've not worked with Jude before. I've met her this morning. She's a lovely girl. She's doing Victoria Carrington Seminole cushions. There's one. And there's the other. Four brand new colourways we're doing today. And we've got the pattern on its own. So if you've got fabric, like Liberty Fabric at home, you want it, got instruction on the road. We'll see you in 3 minutes from now.
If you'd like to get in touch with us during our live show and send in any messages or any questions, then you can do it on studio@sewingstreet.com. Alternatively, you can message us on our official Facebook page.
Are you a fan of Sewing Street and Yarn Lane? Why not join our growing Facebook fans pages? Just search Sewing Street Fans and Yarn Lane TV Fans on Facebook and click Join Group. It's that simple. Never miss out on the latest news and updates from our presenters and guest designers, special offers and plenty of chat with your fellow fans. Share photos of your makes, ask for advice, interact with your favourite guests and presenters and be a part of the ever-growing sewing and yarn community. See you there.
Keep up to date with what's on Sewing Street and Yarn Lane, as well as all the latest news and special offers by signing up to our email newsletters. For Sewing Street, head on over to www.sewingstreet.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and you're done. It's exactly the same for Yarn Lane. Head on over to www.yarnlane.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and that's it. You are now subscribed to both Sewing Street's and Yarn Lane's email newsletters, so you'll never miss out on the latest news and special offers ever again. know that shopping online can be a confusing and sometimes daunting task, and sometimes all you want to do is talk to a human being. Well, our family-run customer service team are on call 24/7. They're full of friendly, warm-hearted individuals, all trained to make your shopping experience as easy and as enjoyable as possible. And not only will they take your order, they will also help and guide you on your shopping journey so you never miss out.
If you're a Sewing Street or Yarn Lane customer, no matter how many times you check out in one day, you will only pay one postage and packaging. So don't wait to add the item you want to your basket and check out. You will only pay one P&P even if you check out multiple times in one day. Miss the live show? Don't worry, we recorded it for you. Never miss out on your favourite presenters, guests and makes ever again. Head on over to our YouTube pages to watch back the day's live show and enjoy your favourite demos over and over again. We also have lots of great content exclusive to our YouTube pages, such as product demonstrations, troubleshooting videos, and so much more. Subscribe and turn on the bell notification so you never miss a show or video ever again. If you'd like to get in touch with us during our live show and send in any messages or any questions, then you can do it on studio@sewingstreet.com. Alternatively, you can message us on our official Facebook page.
Are you a fan of Sewing Street and Yarn Lane? Why not join our growing Facebook fans pages? Just search Sewing Street Fans and Yarn Lane TV Fans on Facebook and click Join Group. It's that simple. Never miss out on the latest news and updates from our presenters and guest designers, special offers, and plenty of chat with your fellow fans. Share photos of your makes, ask for advice, interact with your favourite guests and presenters, and be a part of the ever-growing sewing and yarn community. See you there!
Now, Jude's here today. I've not met Jude before, so we'll have a little gossip during the hour. But we are making Victoria Carrington Seminole cushions, which I absolutely adore. Now, if you have a look at them, you're going to think, oh, I won't be able to make those. Oh, they're too fiddly. I won't be able to do that. Because it looks like you're doing such tiny, tiny, tiny work, doesn't it? But the whole thing about Seminole is it's just the most brilliant, brilliant, brilliant technique. So what I'll do is I'll take you through the different colourways that we've got before we start, and then we'll go to Jude and we'll start making them, demoing them and everything. So the one that Jude made already is this one. So what you get in the bundle is you get the instructions. These might be a bit shiny. Oh, no, they get the instructions. Now, you know how thorough Victoria Carrington's instructions are. Then you get 1 metre of the dits, you get half a metre of the cream, and then you get 3 fat quarters, grey, lemon, and the rose, for £33.99. Beautiful. The one that Jude is demonstrating is this one. So in this one, you get the pattern. This is Liberté. It's lovely, isn't it? You get a metre of that. You get half a metre of the, I think that's ivory, is it? Or is that cream as well? Then you get the same fat quarters in that one. You get the pink, the rose, the lemon, and the grey, the soft grey in that one. £33.99. Then I've got two other choices. So I'll do this one first. So this one, you get the instructions. You get a metre. Oh, I love this. A metre of this. Liberté, you get half a metre of the ivory, and then this time you get a lemon, a grey, and a blue as your fat quarter. That's going to work beautifully, isn't it? You won't be seeing this one being made. You have to visualise that one. Now, a little Paul will do a little computer graphic, if you like, for later, yeah. And then, now, we think this one's Christmas. We think this one might be a bit Christmas. It might not be. It's, you get the instructions. So you get Moda. 1 meter. It might not be Christmas. It could be, or it might not be. Come in close and have a look at that, Paul. Oh, I thought they were hollies. They're not hollies. No. They're little sprigs with berries. They're wintry, but they're gorgeous. Then, so you get a meter of that, half a meter of your cream or your ivory, and then this time, you get the lemon, the pale grey, but then you get that lovely sort of sagey green. Is it sagey? Anyway. Beautiful, isn't it? So that one's also $33.99. We also have the pattern on its own. You might have your own stash that you want to make it out of. Paul's got a mustache. He hasn't got to stash your fabric then. Okay. $9.99. Now, these are really good value because you get so much information in there. She's been photoshopped in that picture, don't worry. That'll have cost her a fortune to make herself look like that, won't she? $9.99. She'll be watching. Oh, loads. We had loads of reviews on this about how clear the instructions are, how they're easy to follow. In fact, Jude was just saying earlier when we were talking that they are fantastic, fantastic to follow. Okay, now we're going to get on with the demo. So, morning.
Morning.
Not met before.
I know. Nice how to meet you. I'm and good.
Good, good, good. Now, before we start any sewing, what are you doing here? How did you get here?
Long drive.
I don't mean this morning. I meant, how come you're on Sewing Street?
I was one of the competition winners.
Okay.
For the big British Make Off kind of thing.
Before I came. Yeah. And what is this your job? Do you do this for a living?
I have a job as well, but I have my own business. I started maybe like 2 years ago.
Okay.
So I do a lot of textiles with that, and I've just started doing more screen printing and things because that's what I did at uni.
Oh, brilliant.
Like specialised in
printing.
Where
did you go to university then?
In Nottingham Trent.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, loved it.
He'll have been there a long time. A friend of mine did fashion there, and he's a very successful fashion designer in Cheshire now. So have you got an Instagram that we can follow then?
Yeah, it's the Making Magpie. The Making Magpie.
The Making Magpie.
Yeah.
And that's got all your screen prints and your fabrics.
That's got everything.
Oh,
so it's all just homeware, really. I love doing it.
And dungarees, Cat.
And dungarees. Oh, I know. I didn't have a new pair to wear today, so I had to
something else. Oh, no.
I know. I've been too busy. I didn't have time to make
How long have you been away from... How long ago did you finish college at university?
God, 3 years this year.
Oh, don't say it like that, because mine's 43.
It's so scary. I worked it out the other day, and I was like, oh, my God, graduated
yeah,
3 years ago.
Yeah, last year.
Okay, 2 years then. 2 years
yeah,
is fine.
Yeah, 2 years. Oh, well, welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank I'd you.
Lovely to see you. So now, you were saying when you like a pattern to be... picked or you learn by visual, don't you, rather
yeah.
than written down. So
yeah.
you were saying that this pattern is really good.
Really,
it?
Really easy to follow, yeah. Because I usually, if I'm struggling, I'll usually go on YouTube and find something on there. Because otherwise, like sometimes I find instructions, just the words confuse me. But yeah, this one was really easy. And even all the pictures are all annotated and all the way through it says fabric B and stuff like that, or fabric A, so you can jot down
yeah.
what you've got yourself as well, so you're not getting confused.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. And we all know Victoria Carrington as well, so and we love her and adore her. So where do we start with this then? What's the first thing we need to do?
Which cushion would you like me to do?
Which one would you like to do? We've got options, because you've got them both over there. If you want to take that, you tell us which one you want to do first, so you can do that.
We'll do
first.
This one.
Okay.
I think this is the one that I made first,
right.
So have a little look. It looks a lot more daunting than what it is, I think.
Yes. Oh, no, when you look at them, it's
yeah.
terrifying.
And I'm not going to lie, it did take a while to do. So if you've got someone to help you cut things out
okay.
and things like that, get them involved.
But also, it's not the kind of project you're going to do in an afternoon. It's
no,
going to be one
yeah.
that you love and cherish and yeah. do, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a good lockdown project, at
yeah.
least, even though we're coming out of it now.
Yeah.
But still.
Slowly but surely.
Oh, I know.
So where are you starting, then?
Right. So a lot of it looks... daunting with that, but it's really just strips of fabric.
Okay.
And in the instructions it tells you need to do an inch and a half of this or an inch of this, so as long as you follow it and just keep referring back to it and things like that. But in the book it's quite good as well because it has
other way, you show it the other way to you, that's it.
There
it.
We go.
That's it.
These little section here
yeah.
where it shows the sample fabrics that she's used in the book, and you can tape your own fabrics onto it so you can keep referring back.
So you keep referring back to it.
Yeah, right? Which was way, way easier for me to do. And then it gives you all the measurements so you can do all the cutting to begin with, so you're not having to waste your time going back and forth.
I like the fact that you write on your pattern.
Yeah.
I think that's good, because when if you come to it again in the future, if you've made notes and everything, you don't fall down
yeah.
the same potholes and things.
Yeah, definitely. So then for block one, to do, you start off with this middle section here, so all the little diamantes. So you would just start off, I think it's like an inch and a half, and then 3 1-inch sections, and then another inch and a half sections like that. And then you cut it into 1.5-inch sections.
Right.
So it's just linear there, and then you cut it into 1.5 sections.
Okay.
And then it's quite good because as long as you've got your iron handy all the way with you.
Which you need to have,
yeah. Oh, God, yeah. It shows you in the book as well which way to iron your seams.
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, and which way to line them up.
I mean, she's very thorough, Victoria Carrington, anyway. Isn't she?
Yeah, this is the first one I followed of hers as well, and it was really... Mm-hmm. I would do it again, definitely.
Oh, she's messaging. She says that photo's not photoshopped, it's just very old. Oh, she says she's looking forward to your demo, Jude. No pressure.
Oh, exciting. Oh, no.
Okay, now, we'll just go as well. You don't use a rotary cutter, do you?
No, I should, because it would have taken me way less time.
Yeah.
But mine was rubbish, so I just had to do it all with scissors.
Your rotary cutter was rubbish?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't have a good one. I think it's dead old. So yeah. But no, I like using scissors. I got a new pair for Christmas, so they were nice and fresh.
But it just takes a little bit longer with scissors, doesn't it?
Yeah,
also,
definitely.
Did you, when you're doing it with scissors, so on a rotary cutter, obviously, you put your blade, your ruler down and just slice. Do you mark the line with your fiction pen and then literally cut?
Yeah, which is why it took so long and why I got my mum involved.
Oh, right, okay.
While she was off work. So, yeah, cutting. I think it's 1.5-inch sections, it looks about right. And then, so to go from this to this, what you do, if we have a little look, you have to, like, sandwich your seams. I can't remember what she said it was called. There was some term for
it. Okay, some terminology.
Yeah. It was nest the
seams.
Yeah,
nest them, yeah.
That's the one. I'm not a quilter, so this is all new to me as well.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's quite good, though, that if you're not a quilter,
yeah,
that you're doing it. So some people at home going, oh, well, I'm not a quilter, I'll never be able to make those.
Yeah.
Actually,
oh, yeah, yeah. I've done a couple patchwork things, but it's generally just like big squares.
Yeah.
Because I would never even attempt this if I.
You weren't told to by us.
Yeah, it looks too daunting for me, but honestly, it was so easy to follow. So you nest your seams, so obviously right sides together, and it creates this diamond effect. It's like a step-up effect.
Yes.
So then once it's angled right, and you obviously cut it down to size, so you would nest these two together.
Right.
And flip, and you get this diamond effect like that.
Uh-huh.
So once that's all
sewn. So literally making like a staircase of the pieces. Yeah.
Yep. So then once that's all complete, I think the cushion itself is about 12.5 inches wide at the end. So then it gets to something like this when you're done.
Right, okay.
Not including this mix.
Yeah, yeah. So you've sewn all them together, however many Victoria says you sewed them all together.
Yeah.
Then you said you trim the edge.
Right. I think it's 1.5 inches or something like that.
Yeah.
But I'll just roughly. So obviously you do this before you sew the other bit on, and you would measure it properly, but I haven't got my ruler now.
Oh, a whole wall of rulers behind you. You need one.
Goodness.
Okay, so you trim down that middle section that you put together, right?
And again, it's a lot easier once you've ironed it and stuff like that, because it lays a lot flatter. And the fabric can be a bit springy just because it's basically like on a bias as well after that. So it should iron into place once you're done. So that's pretty much the first section.
Okay, and then what's super the two? Simple. What's the? I can see ivory and a like kind of the red pinky strip.
So that is these two strips here, like either side.
Okay, and they're literally just two strips sewn on.
Super, super easy, yeah. So all it is, I think it was just 1 inch or 1.5 inches, maybe again, of just the ivory. So I do have another one, so I'll sew that on. And then you get these little ones that I think 3/4 inch.
Right.
And you iron those in half.
Uh-huh.
So it makes like a really thin one.
Oh, so it's like a piping without the piping in it. I see. So that one's not a laid down section.
No, so it's more for texture. So there's 4 of those.
Brilliant.
Which everyone loves a bit of texture.
Yeah.
I do a lot of texture within my work. It's always nice. So then you just, the 1.5, this one. So you just lay that on. And just be careful, because obviously there's so many seams at the back there that sometimes it can catch and things. But it's generally fine.
And is it a 1/4-inch seam allowance on the pattern then?
There is, yeah. which makes it so much easier, so you don't have to worry about adding it or anything like that afterwards, because it's always a nightmare, isn't it, trying to line things up afterwards.
Also, when I did pattern drafting opposite college, and all the patterns I did, you don't have seam allowance on, you have to add your seam to it. So I'm quite, you know, was quite shocked when I came to this, that everyone adds the seam allowance already on it. Sort of
because I never did that. I always add it like...
afterwards, when you're cutting it out. Yeah, yeah, exactly. I think that's what we taught at college. And then when you see patterns with it already in, it's kind of was so a bit much, alien to begin with, but much easier.
And I always think, oh God, am I going to make it too small? Like when I was making my dungarees, I was thinking, oh God, they're going to fit on, squeeze on in. So yeah, you just have to, you just have to pull it a little bit, the underneath section, so that it does stretch, but it is really easy to, if I can get it
not letting you in there, is it?
Oh no. There we go. Is the machine
on? Switched on. Is it, there's a button at the side.
There we go. And then.
Did you do reverse at the end?
Did I do what, sorry?
A reverse stitch at the end, or did you just go straight for it?
Yeah, I did do a reverse, I don't think you have to, but it's just to secure it.
Yeah.
And if you wanted to pin it, I'm sure you could. But because they're quite straight edges and things like that, you can see, and it's not too bad. So yeah, that's just on there. And again, you would press that seam open. And again, it shows on here, there's all the little arrows, so it says press the seams downwards.
That's so thorough, isn't it?
Yeah, and even on this one where you have to nest the seams, it shows you like which direction of each one, so you get the right way around to the fabric and things like that as well. And especially because it looks quite complicated, it makes it so much
easier for you. Yeah, the bits are brilliant, aren't
they? Yeah, because I've never seen a pattern book like that as well before that does that. So well done to her.
Yeah, she needs to get a life, that's what she needs to do.
There's not an eye in here, is there? But we'll be fine. Right, and then, so that's the middle section complete.
Okay.
Super easy. Once you get the hang of it, and once you know which way everything goes, dead simple.
Do you need an iron? You're saying? What are you saying, Kat?
Well, if possible, please. Yeah, thank you. Not very prepared, am I? And then.
Show the cushion while Kat brings the iron in. Just stay a metre away, Kat. You're right, we're on the cushion. And the ironing pad's here if you need to put the iron against the flexibility.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, brilliant. Right.
And then, so it's these two sections here that it still shows.
Okay, so you've
now
done the central section. You've then added the flat stripe and the piping that's not piping.
Yeah.
Now you're going to add the next section.
Yeah. Right. In the book, it does show you to do this first section and then these two, and then add the ivory. But obviously, just
you're just working your way out from the middle. Yeah, exactly.
But I mean, if you find it easier to do, I don't know. Some people might read the instructions all the way through first, but I just go for it.
We always say, sit down with a cup of tea or a glass of wine, read it from cover to cover.
Do you?
No.
Yeah. Not just me then.
No, I'm really impatient. I'm doing something, I just get on with it.
I do as well. And you learn. You learn that way, either mistakes or not, really. So there we go, nice and easy. And it looks way better already.
So what course did you do? I'm going to keep asking you questions. What course did you do?
Decorative arts.
So does that include sewing then?
Yeah, but it's not a course anymore now, which is really sad. Yeah, because not enough people. They didn't like promote it enough, I don't think. But it was honestly amazing. I did ceramics. It was like all in first year. It was ceramics, wood, metal, embroidery, print.
Oh,
and
my word.
Glass. So you got to do everything in first year.
That sounds fantastic. It was did you have to do a foundation before you went? Or
no, I did do a foundation at Carlisle, but I just went to Notts after and loved it.
So that was the first year. Then what did you do the next year?
And then the second year, you choose two topics. So I chose embroidery and print.
Okay.
Because I am like textiles based. I did love doing ceramics,
yeah,
but I just wasn't any good at it. And then in third year, you just specialise on the one that you do. But it was such like a free course. Like I did upholstery for my final year.
How brilliant.
Yeah, like printed my own fabric and then upholstered a chair.
So when did you learn to sew then, while you were there? Because you were doing different...
No, my grandma taught me to sew, like when I was little, just doing like cross stitch and things like that. and like taught me how to knit and stuff like that, because she was like amazing. Yeah. Like she made wedding dresses and stuff for mum and everyone. And then, yeah, from then on, I just loved doing it. And we used to just do crafty stuff all the time as kids.
Yeah.
And then I went to college to do it. I did it at school, but there was only two of us in the textiles class. Uh-huh. So I was like, oh God, no, I need to go to uni.
Yeah.
So I went to Carlisle College, did a year there, and then went to uni to do it.
Oh, wow.
But I can't imagine myself doing anything else. So.
And then what, the people who are on your course, what kind of jobs have they gone into then?
A lot of them, well, it's just lockdown as well, so it's
well, no, I know it's awkward, been difficult, but...
But a lot of them, like one of the boys on my course, he does like sewing as well. So he works for like a pet company kind of thing that does like sewing and stuff. But a lot of them
pet,
have like...
making pet baskets and pet
Yeah, like collars and things like that. Wow. Yeah, it's really good. But he's got his own business as well, doing his own thing. Another of them does like graphic design. So it's just, so it's really, a lot of different
things. Basically, it's a springboard into, yeah. You can use the course to go whichever way you want to with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. Because there was a business module in it as well, which was good. So you kind of get an idea for
what
everything.
What a shame that's gone to the wall.
I know, it is really sad. Because yeah. I think fine art took over.
Oh no. Claire said that, just a message from Claire saying, I've never fancied going to university, but that course sounds fantastic.
Honestly, it was amazing.
It's just such a shame that things like that, because I think a lot of people, when I went to university, you went, like, my first degree was in teaching, you went to do a job, you know what I mean? Like, my brother went to be a doctor, I went to be a teacher.
Yeah.
But now it's you go to university to just people do psychology explore, or law, but they don't want to be an actor or something like that. I think it's just a way of moving on to the next stage in life,
isn't it? Oh, yeah, definitely. And I think obviously it is harder, like, in art and design and stuff like that, and especially where I live, there's not many.
Where's that, then, Winter?
Cumbria.
So, nice, though. It's beautiful.
Oh, yeah, it's lovely, but design-wise, you're stuck.
But then a lot of it is done on the internet these days, isn't it?
Definitely.
So it doesn't matter, sort of, where you are in the world.
Which was definitely a good thing for me over lockdown, like, trying to promote and stuff like that, because I've been on furlough for however long. I know.
Aww.
But it's
are you not, are you back, not back at your other job yet then?
I was maybe back this weekend, but
oops. Well, let's hope not on Tuesday.
He's let me
now.
Off, thankfully.
Oh, they know you're here. That's
he's fine. He'll be watching.
Okay. Right, okay, so where are we on to? So on to the next section with the zigzags, the little
yes,
chevrons.
Which when it's ended, it should look like this.
Righty ho.
Righty ho. So and then once it's done, so it's little triangles and
so
things
it's exactly
like that.
The same. Have you are you gonna do it?
Yeah. So it was, if you can visualise, just two strips like this all the way along.
Okay. Two straight strips,
yeah. All of it is just strips, which is what confused me to begin with, because I was thinking, oh God, am I gonna have to cut all these little diamonds
off? Yeah, and you don't want to sew tiny little diamonds like that, because the machine's gonna chew them up.
Yeah, completely. Yeah. So it was just like this the whole way, and again, you just have to, it's getting your head around this bit that I struggled with.
Yeah.
So you have to, which way up is it? There we go. Where this seam ends, yeah. Don't know if you can see.
Hang on, let Paul just come down a little bit so I can see that. Oh, don't look at the other screen to make you dizzy. We can see on our other screen, you see Paul moving the camera and it makes sometimes makes you look a bit seasicky. Right, go on.
So where it is, you can see on the other side of this, if I move that out of the way, it's like a step up again.
Yeah.
So where this seam ends, that one starts, if that makes sense. So it's like, all of it is like little steps.
Uh-huh.
So then what you would do is put that onto there. So I'm not explaining this very well.
No, yeah. So you basically put the yellow against the yellow, the grey against the grey, but where the last seam finishes, you just put the beginning of the next seam, and you nest these as well, like you did before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And because you've got that quarter inch seam allowance, it should theoretically be the same either time.
Yeah.
But I mean, some of mine aren't perfectly straight, and you don't notice once the cushion's made.
Yeah.
Because I was panicking about that as well. I was like, oh, I'm not going to get it right, but you don't notice, and it's more handmade that way, isn't it?
Morning, John and Jude. It's nice to see someone from the north of England. I miss the accent. I'm from Sunderland, now living in Aberdeen.
Lovely.
Aww. And Amanda says, I bought this pattern ages ago and I've been brave enough to try it, but I will now. Yeah. Thank you, Jude.
Go for it.
And then there's Claire saying, I never fancied university, but that course sounds fantastic. Aww.
It was. Honestly, it was amazing. I wish I could go back.
So if you look forward, where do you think you're going to go? What direction do you think you're going to go in?
Well, before lockdown and things, I started doing a lot of like workshops, like screen print workshops and things. So I'd love to like carry on with that.
Teaching them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's like what I absolutely love, like, screen printing and things like that. And I've just got, like, a nice new machine backing, you know, if anybody wants anything done.
Well, no, but the thing is, I think a lot of people go to places like Cumbria and I think creative people go, you know what I mean? Yeah. You're saying, oh, it's difficult for business, but actually it's the kind of place where a lot of creative people will go. So if you did do, like, make it a destination and you say, do a weekend course on screen printing, then people will come up, stay, and because it's a beautiful area and everything like that as well.
There is a couple places, like, when I was looking at, like, just researching and things like that, there's a couple places that do that and have, like, a weekend spa kind of thing and do, like, little arts and crafts and stuff.
It's not called little arts and crafts.
Sorry.
It's your career.
I mean, yeah, big things.
But yeah, no, but I think that it's a brilliant idea because I think people will venture up there, do you know what I mean? And I think it's for people like writers and artists and painters will all go there for inspiration as well. So I just think it's a really good idea.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
And I was, like, nervous to teach the first one, but I went into schools and things like that. My mum's a head teacher, so I practiced on her kids.
Oh, that's
so
nice.
That was fine. Yeah. she was happy doing that, being the guinea pig.
Oh. But I think kids, this day and age, kids are, no, I don't mean kids, school children, are willing to learn. Like, if somebody came to my school all those donkeys years ago, we're going to do screen printing, we'll be like, oh, man. But I think now, because people will see that you make dungarees and they will use that as an inspiration to create their own. They might not be brilliantly made when they start, but you know what I mean? It'll give them inspiration.
Oh,
like a local girl, it's now like making dungarees and they're all designer and trendy on an Instagram and everything like that. You know what I mean? And also, we can thank social media, can't we?
Because
you'd been in Cumbria 40 years ago, nobody would have heard of you, you know, apart from the people in your local village.
Exactly,
Whereas now it's like a global village, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm stopping you.
Sorry.
So you just start sewing those with your quarter inch seam.
Yeah. So you just sew right down. And then. So again, just like a little step up.
Uh huh.
So again, yellow to yellow, and then I don't know if you can see here. So where this grey one ends, the yellow, it should be like that seam line there.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
And also, it's also I haven't got a instructions book open, but as you say, everything is told to the nth degree, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Completely. Like, I wouldn't have known to do that if I would have been looking for ages at the things if she hadn't said it properly.
Yeah.
At the pictures, and again, just iron that open. So it goes from like little rectangles to squares as well.
Uh huh.
Because I thought.
Princess says, "Lovely to meet Jude, a new face on Sewing Street. Isn't she beautiful and so calm?"
Oh, stop!
It's her fake eyelashes. That's what it is.
I know. Lockdown. I'm done. I've been waiting to get them done.
Oh yeah, because Hannah, the other producer here, this week she's had her eyebrows threaded. She's had her eyelashes lifted. She's had her nails.
Don't blame
her.
Yeah. I don't blame her. I think the beauty industry will be absolutely raking it in now. There we are. Nice.
Perfect.
And ironed. So yeah, I've already done this line, but I think it's like a quarter inch or something like that from each point.
Right. Okay.
But don't worry if it's not like exact or anything, because as you can see, it kind of like bends and twists wants. So it should be an inch.
So you then trim it down, so the zigzags down the middle, So if you had your rotary cutter again, you'd do it with a ruler and just zip it up, you draw the line on.
I really need to invest in a good one because...
The thing is, it's the blade that's the most important.
That's what it was. It was cutting some bits and not the other
mine. Yeah, no, you just need to change
your
blade.
So I was struggling.
Oh, go on, Kat. Okay, message on the bottom saying, "Hi, John and Jude. I've not tried anything like this before, but Jude is making it look easy. Thank you. Oof. I'm looking forward to trying it." From Shirley in Lincolnshire. Oh, thank you, Shirley.
I can't see.
No, you can't see that far.
I'm like this.
No, I have trouble reading those as well. I'm a lot older than you, but I have to lean forward like this to read.
I haven't got my specs on.
Do you wear glasses?
Yeah, I have to wear them all the time.
So aren't you wearing them now?
Got my contact in. Oh, but they're
not working.
They're not half as good. They're awful, honestly.
Maybe you need to get that sorted.
Yeah,
as well. Your rotary cutter and your
I'll get my appointments.
Yeah. Right, okay, so you cut that down to a strip that's about an inch wide.
Yep. So once you've done the same thing again, so again, you can see on the cushion, it's like pattern, ivory,
piping.
Ivory, pattern. So it's kind of like repetitive as well, which is nice because it's like really symmetrical as well.
Yeah.
So once we've done this, I think I've done that too long, but it's fine. We can
cut it down,
We can cut it off. So you just line this up. Oh, I think actually you cut it down to 12 and a half inches again.
Right.
So, I don't know if there's one here. This one, 12 and a half. Oh, no, it's not.
Do you want a longer one? You're right with that. You just have to pull it off the. That's it.
There we go. Oh, I think maybe that one is, isn't it?
Take whichever one you want.
It'd be fine.
Are you?
Oh, I'll just measure it up this.
No, we cut it with scissors, right?
Sorry.
No, don't apologise.
There we go. And again, it's just a bit difficult because all of this kind of wants to go the way. So it's sometimes easier to sew with the seam. So like flip it over the other way.
Yeah.
So you're not going against it because it can like pucker and things like that and not look as neat.
There's a big discussion about the houses behind me. They're not Amber Makes, Derek, I don't think, are they? They were Wendy Orlando. They were before I came here. I think Wendy, I don't think she designed them. I wasn't here when they launched, no. I was elsewhere. What were they? Sorry to interrupt. Jude.
No, you're fine. It's nice and quiet, this machine, anyway.
Yeah. Doorstops, they're doorstops. Do we still sell them? No, we haven't got those. I don't know who was that asked. I know that Amber Makes did the Christmas house with the Father Christmas going down the tree, but those are before Amber Makes. They're ones that Wendy Orlando made. I think it was Wendy Orlando, wasn't it? She made them, but it's our Sewing Street design.
So you've got that, so that's okay. One side. So already it looks way better because it's...
It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah. You can have something that doesn't look scrappy, but kind of as soon as you sew something to it, it suddenly takes
so
its own
much
form.
Neater.
And everything,
yeah, completely.
Yeah.
And then I've already pre-put the like little piping-esque...
Yeah, piping, not piping.
Piping, not piping. Onto there.
Right.
So that's the same. So you do exactly the same step on this side. So it kind of like sandwiches it. And I'll sew it this way up this time so that the seams...
Around the top, yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting all confuffled.
Oh, now, while you're saying that, the blue bundle is the most popular. Not surprised. I think that's because on the front of the pattern, it's a blue and yellow one on the front of the pattern. If you look, I just wait for Paul to come over. You see, if you look there, that's a blue and yellow. And this is the most, not most popular, the closest to it, isn't it? And I think when people can actually see, so I imagine this, and we always see the one that's being demonstrated is always very popular as well. So that's $33.99. So you get a metre of the blue, Liberté, half a metre of the ivory, and then the three fat quarters in the blue, the lemon, and the grey. $33.99. Most popular on that one.
There we go.
Okay.
Lovely.
And then that's the panel done. In real life, I know you don't hear, how often do you press? Like in between, you know, like would you wait till the whole thing was together and then press it, or would you press it? Okay, you never don't. Okay.
I don't. I'm so lazy with stuff. I shouldn't say that, should I? But if it was,
it's honest. We're all about honesty here.
If it was something for somebody else, then I'd do it properly. But if it was for myself, I'd be like, nah, I can't
be bothered. Is that weird? I used to be like that because obviously I used to make clothes for people and everything. And if it was someone, or costumes, if it was someone else, you'd give it the most, but then you'd make yourself a shirt and you'd be like, oh, it'd be fine, no one will know.
Oh, yeah. Like when I'm making my own dungarees, sometimes I don't even overlock them because I'm just like, oh, I can't be bothered.
Don't they fall apart in the washing machine?
No, well, I haven't washed them yet, so we'll see. To be continued. If I'm in a rush, I'm like, oh. I think I made some in an hour or something because I was like in that much of a rush to get them done, to wear them. But live and you learn. Right? So this
Paula
is
says, hello, John. What a lovely and interesting lady, Judy. She's doing brilliantly, from Paula.
Oh,
that's nice. Thank you. Thank you, Margaret, for your lovely comments as well.
There we go. So
who said that? Which Jackie? I was going across here. Loving the show today. The strips are called flanges. I don't think they are they? I thought a flange was on a vase. At the top of a vase. No.
I've no idea.
Okay, we're not going there. Okay, it doesn't matter anyway. They may be, and I'm not taking the mickey out of you. Who was it, Jackie, did you say? Jackie, yeah. Anyway, carry on. Paul's being rude now.
There we go.
Have you met little Paul before?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, sorry. Right, okay, then that's it then. So that's how you make the top of your cushion, just put all of them together.
So easy. And Brilliant. Then it's envelope close as well, which I find the easiest.
I much prefer an envelope back, yeah.
Yeah. Because, I mean, zips are fine,
no,
but If I don't have to do them, I don't like a zip, because
if you fall asleep like that, when you're my age, you fall asleep on the sofa and you wake up, there's a zip mark across your face, nothing you can do about it.
I just think they look a lot nicer because you could have it that way as well if you wanted
to. I also think you have to do a generous, which that is, a generous. I don't like envelope backs where you put the cushion in and then it's like gaping.
This one, there's about that much crossover, so it's a good hefty amount.
Perfect. Shall we romp through the next one now?
We shall. So, dead quick that was. Wasn't
if you got any questions, obviously get them in, because Jude and I will answer them. Hmm. What's the matter? Loads of Jude love coming in on the messages.
That's nice.
Right, okay, so then this is the other one. So, I presume it's along the same lines, but just different techniques to create those different
Pretty much,
looks.
Yeah. I don't know which one I prefer, actually.
Which one do you like best, Kat? I think I like the first one.
Yeah.
But I like them both.
I like this bit of it as well.
No, that's exactly what Kat just said. Yeah. She said she likes that bit,
And I think even like in some different colours and stuff, it would make such a different design.
Also, what you could do if you wanted to, if you're making a bigger cushion, you could rather make two different ones, you could put that zigzag next along on this one, make it almost like a bolster and put that, or on the other side or something. You can use it in so many
different
ways.
Yeah, you could have reversible, couldn't you?
Right, okay, so what's this one got then?
So here we go. So again, pretty much the same idea in the fact that you just start with strips.
Yeah.
Loads of strips of fabric to create this middle section here, this diamond thing, which I am a fan of actually. But, so yeah, you just have this and then you cut.
Now that one looks more complicated.
I think just because it's different widths and things like that as well.
So if you're going to make these at home, make this one first.
That's what I did.
And then go on, because this one does look like it's got more.
Yeah.
That one's just like the same sizes also together. Yeah. Whereas this one looks, you've got little squares, big squares, thin stripes, everything like that, haven't you?
And that's how it is in the book as well. This one is the second one to make.
Oh, okay.
So maybe she thought
maybe
that
she
through
thought
as
that
well.
Through, yeah.
She thought it all,
maybe
hasn't
she?
That through. So there we go. So you cut this one into, I think, an inch and a half. This one is slightly thicker. That's why you get... So the yellow on this one is the pink on this one.
Okay.
So even though it's kind of confusing, isn't it? Switcheroo. And then an inch for this one. So you just cut all that way, all the way down.
Uh-huh. Laurie's messaging saying, Judy's doing a great demo and interesting to listen to.
Oh,
love her hair. Lockdown hair, isn't it?
It is. Don't look at the roof.
Tracy says, yes, the striped ones are called flanges, John. Now, Princess thinks you and Paul should do a duet because he could be Paul McCartney and you're Hey Jude. Thanks, Princess. A bed pillow, Laurie says, would be great as well. It would. And I know, Tracy, the bit that I'm calling piping that's not piping, it's called the flange. Thank you. Right. Okay.
Oh, is that the bit that's the flange?
Yeah.
I didn't know what it was.
No, you see, you learn something new every day, don't you?
Little flap.
So let me have a look at this one then from upstairs.
So then...
Oh, sorry.
Here we go. That's perfect. Yep.
So you do the same thing then. So you've sewn your strips together.
Yep.
You cut them.
Yep.
And then you just step them like you did the last one.
I think once you figure out that's all it is, it's like you feel like a lot more relaxed into
it. Yes, yeah, definitely.
Once you realise, oh, it's not as fiddly as you think.
Yeah.
But it is time consuming, but again...
Yeah, because if you didn't do Seminole on this, there's no way you could get... How big would those little yellow, or the pink ones, would be absolutely tiny to stitch in on their own, wouldn't they?
Yeah, completely. Yeah. It'd be an absolute nightmare. Because I think that's only an inch, but obviously once you've taken the quarter off, it's only like half an inch.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, no, you wouldn't want to be...
I couldn't be bothered fiddling with that. My hands
You'd
like,
glue gun them in, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Morning, John and Jude. What a beauty your guest is. Lovely demo and wonderful hair. What is it about her hair?
Stop.
So what colour is it naturally then?
Like brown. Like mousy brown. But I got it dyed like gingery before lockdown and then I just couldn't get it done again. So my mum's been doing me a box dye job.
But she's good job, Mum. She make her do the cutting. She lets you practice on the kids in her school.
She's great.
She dyes your hair.
I know. She's just a woman of many talents, I tell you.
Oh, well, obviously. So who did you arrive with? Who's that lady you arrived with?
My sister.
Now she's creative as well?
Yeah, she does graphic design. She's got her own business as well.
So you dragged her all the way here?
Mm-hmm. I drove on the motorway for the first time yesterday.
Oh, did you?
Mm-hmm. Big girl now.
Well, no, the thing is, Paul said it was a good time to do it on lockdown. I had to drive to, where have I been this week? York. The roads were busier than ever this week.
Were they?
Supposed to be, you're saying, essential travel only, sitting on the motorway, so busy. Mm-hmm. Anyway, So you've sewn the things together the same as we did before.
Yep. And you have to, if you can see on the back again, obviously nice and pressed.
Yeah.
It's the same kind of idea as the zigzags where you step up.
Yeah.
Where you put, like you, what was it called
nesting.
Again?
Nesting.
Nest them. Encrignon. So you nest them so the edge of this seam and the edge of that seam are flat against each other. So it would be like, like this. Uh-huh. So where this ends finishes, that one starts.
Yeah.
And I did it, obviously you cut it all out first. I did it in like two bits and then instead of doing one long strip at a time, I did it at two bits. So it kind of feels like you're not sewing as much. It doesn't feel as long.
Also, I think if you do two bits, two bits, two bits, two bits, two bits, and then join the two bits together.
Yeah.
It's like when you're doing lots of long strips, it has a tendency to start doing that, doesn't it? Whereas if you do two, 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 and then join together, it won't do that bananaing.
So again, once it's done, it comes out with the little squares and things like that.
Okay, and then where'd you trim that one then?
So, again, it's all in the book. If I try and fast forward. Block two, here we go. I think it's like a... Yeah, trim the stitch down, trim the strip down to 12 and a half inches, and it says to make it so that you don't, so you have like equal apart as well. So that I suppose you could have the cushion either way, and it wouldn't look like
And also you don't want to cut through the middle of a square or something like that. You're even.
Yeah.
About, yeah.
Which I suppose it doesn't matter if you do. If you're just making it for yourself and things as well, just to have fun with it. So you want to cut a quarter of an inch above the top yellow.
Right.
And below the top yellow. Right. So I think it does, and it's quite good because it shows you, it tells you here, like how wide the finished strip should be as well.
Yeah.
Which was really good. So before you cut, you can measure and things like that. Just in case. So it's 2 inches, 2.5 inches by 12 and a half inches on that one. So once that's all nice and cut, minus these strips here, it should be like that. So it already looks a lot neater.
Yeah.
Just being with this. And again, this was dead simple. So this was maybe like an inch, two, and then another inch of the
grey. So they're just two stripes on that one. There's no flange on that one.
Just dead simple. Yeah.
Yeah.
The flange comes after.
Oh, okay, right.
These little bits. Don't actually know how I've got it, to be honest with
you. Oh, honestly.
Oh, what am I like? Don't know. Don't know where it is. Might have gone walkabout. Oh, here we are.
Oh, there you go.
And it does say to tack them as well, because you have to sew them.
Yeah.
And then, like, sew the other bit to it, like this.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So at the end, you only see, like, a tiny bit of it.
Yeah.
But to tack it, but I suppose you could sew it like, I think I sewed it with, like, you know, the tiny bit of your machine. I don't even know what that measurement is.
1/8 of an inch.
That's the one. See, you're more technical than I am.
I've been doing it a lot longer than you.
I'm just thinking,
don't worry.
So, yeah, once you've got your thing, your strip all nice and straight and cut, and you sew your grey and your cream to it, your ivory to it. So this is your middle section pretty much complete.
Perfect.
And it's a nice little breather once you get these big strips because you think, oh, I can actually do a nice run on the machine.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Because up till then you've been doing lots of little...
Yeah, lots of little bits. So make sure, I think I had to fill my bobbin up about 10 times or something. Here we go.
So now you're tacking it now then? Or is he attaching it?
I'll just go for it. I did tack it originally, but I don't really know how to change the length on this one. It's different to my machine, it's more fancy.
Oh, don't worry. It's the one with the... It doesn't matter.
Can is that one there?
Yeah, but don't worry.
It'll be fine. I'll just do it
Because I want to see how you do it. How many minutes of the demo have we got left? 7 minutes of demo left.
Oh, that's fine. I'll do that.
I want to see how to do the chevron streppy bit.
I know, that was my favourite.
Okay, and while you're saying that, got more messages. From Joe, love the demo. Judy's great, brave girl too. I thought she meant working with me. I've never driven on a motorway, and I'm 56, but I do live in a tiny island with no motorways. There's no motorways on the Isle of Man. No, we don't stay there. You don't need to drive on a motorway. And one off Ellis, did you say? Please, can we have the two of you Hang on, please can we have the two of you demonstrating again? Jude does have a lovely voice. You spark off each other well. Lindsay from Hemel. Oh, it's either Lindsay or it's Ellis from Hemel Hempstead. Oh, that's very sweet of them.
I know. Oh. I don't think I have a nice voice. You know when you hear yourself back and you're like,
oh no, I can't ever watch myself on the television. Oh, you've got a lovely voice, John. I turn the telly on, I'm like, who's that bloke shouting at me all the time?
So. I know, my mum puts it on when I get home. Come on, everybody, sit down. My grandma, I have to put it on record for my grandma.
Oh, they're not watching?
I think my grandma's got to get her hair done. More important, you see.
Oh, that's way more important.
Well,
then.
Sorry. Yeah. But yeah.
Okay, so talk to me about this. Oh, this is what you're going to do now, this zigzaggy bit.
Yeah,
the one that goes down
this
the
is
one.
The zigzag.
Right.
So again, just as you can see, obviously it's on a slant, this one, but it is just the same as like these kind of ones where you just do three strips.
Right.
And attach. Uh-huh. But the different bit with this, if I was to lay it on there, is you cut it at a four.
Oh, hang on. So you're cutting it at a 45 degree
yeah.
angle, because if you put your yellow on that red, like you can see.
You can see there.
You can see that you actually. So you cut diagonally across the fabric rather
yep.
than cut strips on it.
Yeah. So you only have like a little bit of waist, like a corner
yeah,
of
yeah.
waist there. But again, it looks a lot more complicated than what it is. But mm-hmm. once you've started, so these are all just 1-inch sections. So you get quite a lot out of these.
So do you make one with yellow?
And one with grey.
Okay, got it.
So two of each, so four all together.
Yeah.
Obviously for the two different sections.
Yeah.
And I just, to save time as well, it does actually tell you in the book as well to like sandwich them. So you have like the yellow on the grey.
Yeah.
And pin them and just cut them all at once.
Oh,
so
okay.
you save time as well.
Yeah.
I suppose you could do it separately, but
yeah.
you know, it's quite a long project in itself.
Yeah.
So you might as well save where you can. And then I think this is the most simple bit because it's really easy to line up.
Yeah, you need a yellow one next.
So yeah, just yellow onto the grey.
Yeah.
Nice and simple. And again, the fabric's quite stretchy, so just be mindful.
That's because you're completely on the bias, aren't
yeah.
you?
Yeah.
If I were you, I'd buy some Best Press and give it a quick squirt with Best Press. That'll just stabilise it a little bit.
Is that what it is?
It's we've only got lavender on the Best. It's like
nice.
Just like a squirty thing. Squirt on it. It's not starch, but it just stabilises the fabric. And then if you are sewing on the bias, it doesn't stretch so much. It makes it a bit more stable.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
Yeah.
I'm learning so much.
Oh, there you go. Yesterday there were three left of the lavender. They might not be there anymore. Wendy Orlando buys most of them.
There we are. So super simple. So already you can see it's like a little arrow.
Yeah.
Lovely. So then you would just do the same. And again, I did the same with this, like sewing two, 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 two. And then double up just
yeah.
to save yourself a little bit of time, because it seems like you're sewing forever when you do it one at a time, I think.
Yeah, oh yeah, completely. But then I suppose it depends if the year we've gone through, we need a bit of mindfulness, don't we?
Oh.
Sometimes you want a little repetitive thing to over,
yeah.
so you forget everything that's going on in the world and just being your own.
I find it so relaxing,
yeah.
I know, as sewing. Yeah. And I think that's why so many people have like picked it up. And I think my friend was saying the other day on the Great British Sewing Bee now, a lot of them are lockdown sewers.
Yeah, Raph, I only know him because he works for my friend Dulcie. He's a dyer and printer, and he only took up sewing during the beginning of lockdown. You know what I mean? He does dyeing fabrics for films, and then, you know, because I used to do film costumes, what you do is you never put a brand new costume on something, you have to break it down to make it look worn. And it's a really specialised job, that's what he does.
You wouldn't even think that was a job, would you? It's so
no.
strange to think
it,
about.
But no, but when, I mean,
but I
most films
so
you take two or three breaker downers with you on location and everything, because I suppose it depends how stylised you're making it. So something like Bridgerton, they wouldn't have done breaking down on Bridgerton because it all looked stylised. But if you've got real people, if you
yeah.
make a costume for them, you don't want it looking brand new. Do you want it look a bit rough around the cuffs and a bit faded here.
Yeah.
But that's a job, yeah.
So would they make a shirt from scratch?
Yes. On Bridgerton, everything will have been made from scratch for the principals.
So impressive, isn't it? I'm not into like dressmaking as much, but I want to get into it. That's why I did the dungarees and things, because they were my like lockdown project. Yeah, I just bought the
Maybe you should also look into breaking, because there's very few really good breaker downers for the film industry.
I'm going to search that, you know.
So have a look at it, because it is a specialised art, because If people try and do it without having any training, it can ruin a costume
look
completely.
A bit messy.
But if you know where clothes would wear and where they'd fray and things like that, it's just, and sometimes you wouldn't even know on the film that it had been broken down, but you definitely know if it hadn't been broken down.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's that kind of art. Mm. You know? And yeah, oh, yeah, exactly. And how they would have worn something in those times, Kat's saying.
Yeah.
It's like when you do costumes for film, you have to know about, not just about costumes,
the period
about
and everything.
You know,
yeah.
Kind of, because somebody say, oh, I'll just roll my sleeve up. You go, actually, wouldn't do that. Or somebody say, we'll just have two ladies walking along this scene. You go, no, in 1740s, yeah. Women didn't walk on their own and all that sort of stuff.
It's stuff that you wouldn't even think about, though, is it?
Exactly.
I wouldn't have a clue.
No.
There we go.
Right, you home.
Lovely.
So you just trim that one down.
Yep, so that's an inch either side. So that's pretty easy to
perfect.
Measure. So again, if you had a rotary cutter, nice
would
and
help,
simple.
Yeah. No, but also not everybody, especially dressmakers. See, I'd never heard of a rotary cutter before I came to work. Well, it was a sewing quarter I learned about them. Because obviously I've always used scissors as a dressmaker or costumer. I've always used scissors.
There's nothing better than a sharp pair of scissors, though, is there?
No. Also, I like the noise it makes as well when it cuts.
When the first...
Yeah.
Ooh, lovely. So, yeah, then once you've got your flange on there, where am I at? Here we go. So then this is where that would be attached to there. That's why you've got to do a little tack, just so that once that's attached onto there and flipped over, you don't see the seam.
Right.
Because you're kind of sewing it twice already.
Yeah.
And again, you might have to stretch this a little bit to get it. But
I think the pressing, if you'd press that.
Yeah.
Not if you'd, that sounded rude.
But I know.
If you press it, it will, the seams will stretch out a little bit. So you might not need to stretch it.
Yeah. Completely.
Claire says, sewing is great for both mind and body. It was a gentle exercise I needed 2 years ago when I was recovering from surgery.
Oh.
I was bored and needed to do something. Well, there you go.
I don't blame her.
No. Also, they say, don't they have your ironing board on the other side of the room? So you don't just sit at your desk, sew, and then iron there like Joe Carter does. Get up, walk to that, because that's your little bit of exercise for the day.
Yeah.
Oh, we've had a picture in. From whom? Sujar, hello everyone, an apron with a border and a pocket. Oh, look. So that's the same technique, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's lovely. In fact, that's this one, isn't it? Hang on. It's almost like this one with the little squares in it. That's beautiful. Thank you very much for that.
I feel like it's quite an old technique, this.
It's what?
Quite an old technique.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like people have been doing it for a long time.
Yeah, oh yeah, exactly.
Do you do any quilting and things?
I do, no, I should do. And I did during lockdown at the beginning, I did, you know, when we were putting rainbows in windows,
I did
a sew along on my Facebook channel of how to make a Bargello rainbow. And so people made like a quilted rainbow to go in their window.
Oh,
and
nice.
Now they've taken them down, they've made cushions out of them and things. But I don't do anywhere near as much as I should do, really.
It's just getting the time to, though, isn't
yes,
it? Like,
yeah.
If you're busy, because obviously, just take a lot of time and having the space as well.
Yeah. Oh no, I'm like, well, what happens is I did have an office downstairs in my house, and I took one of the bedrooms upstairs, so my office and the sewing room is now upstairs, so I've got quite a big space upstairs. But I still don't use it.
I know. It's when you come in from work though, you can't really be bothered sometimes, can you?
No.
Even when I finished uni, I didn't want to do any sewing for like a year because I was so sick of it. Because I feel like the pressure and everything of deadlines and things like that.
Oh yeah, yeah, exactly.
So there we go.
Brilliant. And then again, you've just added the sections of your main fabric onto that to make the actual cushion.
So then that would go onto there.
Yeah.
And then there's a 6-inch section either side, which like fills the cushion out.
Brilliant. Fantastic.
And then you envelope back again.
It's lovely, that Liberty fabric, isn't it?
It's lovely. Really nice quality as well.
Yeah, well,
soft.
The thing is, when you have good quality fabric, I think it's easier to sew. Do you know what I mean? The better the quality of the cotton, which we only sell the good quality cottons, but it kind of, not sews itself, but you're not worried about the fabric because it's got a nice stability to it and everything.
I think sometimes a lot of it can like pucker or be like really stiff.
Yeah.
It's exactly. Do you wash them before you use them?
I do on dressmaking, but I'm not so much on quilting and things.
Yeah, same.
Okay, so now you're back in an hour and you're making the, hang on, where are they? Yeah, they're there. You're making the, there you go, there's a still of them. We're making those, we've got a special deal on the book and we've got some bundles. I love that fabric inside. I like that orange fabric because I think it's West Side Story all over. Anyway, thank you very much. I'll just do a recap and we'll see you in an hour's time. Blue first then. So This one, most popular, you get the pattern, you get the meter of the Liberty fabric, you get half a meter of the ivory cream, and then you get a fat quarter of the blue, the grey, and the lemon. £33.99. Those colours work beautifully, don't they? Really, really nice together. Okay, that's that one. Now the next one, this one here, we're calling it Christmassy, but it's not necessarily Christmassy. So we get a metre of your holly-esque fabric. This is Moda. You get half a metre of your, just wait till next week, half a metre of your creamy ivory. And then you get your green, your yellow, and your grey. £33.99. And, oh yeah, there's nothing there to make both cushions. Sorry, I just said that. There's instructions to make both and the fabric to make both in there. Now, do make sure you buy yourself a nice cushion pad because you don't want to be stuffing it with bubble wrap and towels, do you? So I'm saying nothing. Right, okay, so we... The one you were just working with, which is this also Liberté. So that's, I love that fabric. Beautiful. Isn't that called Little Oxford or something like that? I think, or is it Cambridge, that one? I'll tell you now. Cambridge, that's Cambridge Fern, yeah. And then the Oxford was the smaller one. Right, so you get a metre of that, you get half a metre of your ivory, and then you get fat quarter of the rose, the lemon, and the pale grey. £33.99. And then the one that the sample was made out of, is this one here. I'll show you the picture in a second. So you get the instructions, you get a metre of the fabric, half a metre of the cream, ivory, and then rose, lemon, and grey, and that will make you this. And it will also make you that one. So you get both patterns in the instructions, and you get enough fabric to make both of them in the bundle. Right, instructions on their own. Half the stock has gone, half today's allocated stock has gone. Because you might have your own fabric. You might, you know, have your own, you might know your own colour scheme that you want to do them in. Or you might want to make an apron or a bag or anything like that, or a section for your denim jacket or something. Little Paul, well, Little Paul always customises his denim jackets, doesn't he? Oh, in fact, we're doing a denim jacket tomorrow. We're doing a denim jacket tomorrow. Dressmaking day tomorrow. And what? Is there? Oh, Kat's just told me there's a surprise tomorrow. I don't know. Anyway. There's your pattern, $9.99. Grab them now, I would, because these are flying out. All right, we've got to go for a break now. Oh, I've got Kaffe after the break. Now, we launched it earlier this week. We've managed to bundle and realign and everything. So we've got more Kaffe for you coming up straight after this break. In need of a crafting fix? There are so many ways you can watch Sewing Street and Yarn Lane. Sewing Street is live from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. every day on Freeview 72 and Sky 670. Alternatively, if you want to watch us on a tablet or on the move, you can tune in on our YouTube channel, the Sewing Street app, or the websites at www.sewingstreet.com and www.yarnlane.com. You can watch past shows on Sky 670 from 1 p.m. every day, as well as our YouTube channel, the app, and our website. Yarn Lane is on from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Visit our programme guide to find out when and what's on. So you never have to spend a minute without us.
Hello everyone, my name's Cara Ackman and I'm absolutely delighted to be here at Sewing Street. I actually originated from Hertfordshire, then went down to Hampshire, and then it ended up in the East Midlands. I've been in the East Midlands for about 40 years now, which seems crazy. But 36 of those I actually worked with DMC Creative World, which was wonderful. I really, really enjoyed that. And then I decided to go freelance, and that's how I got introduced to Sewing Street. I love doing anything to do with textiles, so embroidery, cross stitch, patchwork, done a bit of quilting, bag making, toy making, oh goodness, there's loads and loads of things. What I love doing is just trying something new, and I think one of the tips is don't be frightened of trying something new. You always learn from it, and you know, don't be scared of making mistakes either. We all learn from the mistakes that we make. little bit about me that you might not know, and that's a bit of a surprise. I once went to the garden party down at Buckingham Palace, the Queen's garden party, for some work that I did with Marie Curie. I was so, so lucky to go there, and just a wonderful time. So I hope to see more of you on Sewing Street, and I hope to try lots of new crafts with you. So see you again soon. Bye-bye.
Have you heard about all of the different ways you can shop with Sewing Street and Yarn Lane? You can either shop on our websites, sewingstreet.com and yarnlane.com. You can also order by phone by calling our friendly UK customer service team. For Sewing Street, call 0800 001 4433 and for Yarn Lane, call 0800 4700 600. And don't forget about the Sewing Street app. Here you can shop all of the Sewing Street products as well as watch the live shows from anywhere. You can download the app onto your smartphone or your tablet by simply searching Sewing Street in your app store. And one final thing, no matter how many times you check out on Sewing Street or Yarn Lane in one day, you will only pay one postage and packaging. Happy shopping!
Stuck for ideas for the perfect gift? Why not get them a gift card? You can buy Sewing Street and Yarn Lane gift cards loaded up with anything from £10 to £500. Shop our gift cards online at www.sewingstreet.com or www.yarnlane.com, or purchase them via our UK call centre on 0800 001 44 33. Well, just sanitising. I'll be with you in a moment. What are you doing back in here? Jude's just come back into the room. You're taking the sewing machine. Yeah. She's hiding behind the desk. She's, there she is.
My sister's got a job for
her. Oh, no. Her sister's, what's your sister called?
Sarah.
Sarah. Sister's got a job for her to do. What, she split something?
I've made her a table plan. She does weddings.
Oh, she does weddings.
Yeah.
No, she can't eat. She hasn't got a microphone on, but she's got a table plan that she's doing. I thought you were going to Greg's. All right, I'll see you in an hour. Right, okay. Now, when we launched this fabric this week, it was such a busy show, I can't tell you. There were some fabrics that sold out on their own. All these bundles that you see here, all completely sold out. The blue one sold out immediately. I haven't got a blue bundle today. For some reason, the computer's rejected it. But I've got all the fabrics, so don't worry. All these bundles sold out. We were just able to readjust and realign everything. Now, I haven't got huge stocks today. So if you do want any of these, you do need to get a wriggle on. Okay, purple is most limited. So let me push that to that side, that to that side. Now this is from the new Kaffe 2021 range. February. Yeah. Now some of the patterns you'll recognize, they've recolored them. What they've done, because you'll recognize that one. You see, but you didn't see it in that colour before. And you'll recognise feathers, but you didn't see it in that colour before. When we're at Sewing Quarter, right, the minute we showed feathers, not in this colourway, it sold out in seconds, right? And it was the same. Oh, actually, when I come to the pink, it's this feathers, isn't it? That feathers coming up in a minute, right? That's only available in the bundle because it's sold out by the half metre. Anyway, let's just do this. So here's the purple bundle. So you get, rhododendron, hydrangea, cactus flower, feather, damask, and shark's teeth. And I did that without Kat helping me. Right, okay, I need to tell you there are only 7 of these bundles left. That's it. Also, I'm presuming when this is gone, that's it. I don't know if we've got any on reorder or whatever. So this whole bundle, 100% cotton, machine washable, Kaffe Fassett design, £36.99 for 2.5 metres. Beautiful, isn't it? Okay, now which solid would I put with this bundle, Kat's saying? Personally, I'd either put that one, which is called magenta. Are you going to put the graphic, or are we just going to talk about it now? Okay, magenta. I will do try black next year. Hang on, is it coming in the other side? There you go. Now, ignore last few chances. Okay, I also like the black with this. The black's very dramatic. There you go, black. Then we've got Imperial. Oh, this one's purple. Oh, what's the difference between purple and Imperial? Oh, now that looks a bit blue on your telly. It's amethyst purple. It's more like the picture in the box than it is the what you're seeing on the telly. I wouldn't do the green. I wouldn't do the navy. I wouldn't do the white. Okay, that's it. That's it. That's it. So now, how many of these have I got left now? One, two, three. Right. Okay, I've only got six of these left, but there are seven in baskets, just to warn you. Right, now we'll do these fabrics by the half meter. Excuse me. So we'll start off with hydrangea. Now, this is feet. Oh, no, Kat, can I make a decision? Can I do the book next? Is that all right? I don't want to tell you how to do your job. Only because these fabrics are featured in this book. This is Kaffe's brand new book, right? Kaffe Fassett in the studio. Behind the scenes, now this is meant to be £30. It says in the cover, it's £30. Oh, what? Why? Oh, so who made it £27.99? Oops. Okay, so it should be £30. Apparently it was Kat that clicked on a box that took it to £27.99. It should be £30. It is £30 elsewhere. And also, it's not on pre-order anymore. It's ready to go. It's ready to come to you. Isn't that beautiful? Look, look, you're going to love this. There's even pictures of his bathroom in here. This is his house and his studio, look. A peek behind the curtain, studio and home life. Look, I said, imagine trying to dust that. I think he might have dressed it a little bit. You couldn't live with it like that all the time, could you? There's what this is. Oh, look, there's his design wall. You know how we have the design wall? We haven't got it today, but it's available on the website. Then look, all his books. There's him and Brandon. The painting studio. Look, isn't it glorious? It's just, this is the living room. Look at that wallpaper. I'd love that wallpaper. I wonder if you can buy, okay, I wonder if it's, that is wallpaper or whether he's painted those on the wall. I don't know if he's got a wallpaper range. We'll have to look that one up, won't we? Then you've got your needlepoint and everything like that. Cushions. This is dining room. I know. Beautiful. Up the upstairs kitchen. Excuse me. Has he got two kitchens, do you think? The bathroom. It's just exquisite. But the reason I did this was I don't want to show you the whole book, so I don't want to spoil it off when you get home. But look, there's patterns in the back and how to do things. But isn't there, I'm sure there's a picture of him painting this fabric. That's why I got all excited. It's a beautiful coffee table book, this, isn't it? I was convinced there was a picture. I said I wasn't going to show you all. Hang on. Where is, oh, here we go. Here you go. I knew there was a picture. That's him drawing this design. Look. Hydrangeas from his garden. Look. So this is obviously a different colourway I've got here. But isn't it beautiful? I'm not going to show you any more of the book, though, only because I don't want you to have seen every single page by the time it arrives at your house. Beautiful. Anyway, look. The book. Oh, you can buy the book, but this is the fabric now. We're doing all the purples by the half metre now. Oh, hang on, yeah, let me move that because that's, oh, that's confusing me a bit there. There you go. So now it is, I'll show you, I can open this out, Paul, I'm going to hold this up if that's right. That's, now you're buying by the half metre, right? So, but, when it's in the bundle, they're already cut. If you want to make a frock out of that, or maybe you want to make something else out of it, you can, now's your chance to buy it by the half metre. Oh, no, we said that the other day. If you've got a Darku's book, right? Now, I just need to explain something about a Darku's book. A lot of people have said to me, it's a beautiful book, but I don't want to use African wax cotton. You don't have to. You don't have to at all. It's because the book is called Working with African Wax Cotton. So people thought, oh, you can only make what's in the book. The dress patterns, or you know the jumpsuit that Hannah's going to make for herself, be beautiful in this. Just be careful how you place, how you do your placements, though. You know what I mean? Yeah. Right, okay, so I'll move on from that one. Oh, there's only one purple bundle left. There's only one of the bundle left. Crikey. Oh, love this, love this. This is cactus flower. Now, I have got this in different colours. This is one, this is called emerald, this one. See, Paul, the whole hour we kept saying, oh, Paul's like a shirt in this, Paul's like a shirt in this. Okay, I'm going to be completely honest with you. I've only got 13 and a half metres of this fabric left. That's it. Because remember, the bundle's about to sell out. So, you know what I mean? Somebody could come, like a couple of people come in and buy 3 metres for a dress. Isn't it lovely? To be cut off the bolt, especially for you. Cat's kind of envisaging your story now. That somebody goes into the warehouse and goes, right, Suzanne would like 3 metres of this, please. They cut it with your name on it. Oh, little Paul. It's little Paul's birthday in 10 days' time. He wants somebody to make him a shirt. You'll only need half a metre. That's enough. A what collar shirt? What's a Cuban collar? Okay. I'll have to look that one up. Oh, hang on. Sold out, has it? Sold out. Sold out. And that means the feathers in the blue and the pink are sold out now. I told you that to be quick. Well, this is called Damask or Damask. Beautiful, isn't it? You could make a mask out of it if you wanted to, Paul. Yeah, top of parasols. I think it looks like a daisy, to be honest. Oh. All Three Spirit, all beautiful, beautiful colours. All brand new. We only launched it this week. Isn't it lovely? Just doing a recap because we know it's going to all go. We know it's all going to go. Okay, now I've got the shark's teeth. Oh, now, hang on, it's that way. Oh, hang on. Oh, you see, Paul's seeing orange triangles. I'm seeing purple triangles. Alison Marion's going to make your shirt, Paul. Alison Marion's going to make your shirt. Yeah. She's put here. I'll make you a shirt, Paul. You have to buy the fabric, Paul. The one he wanted sold out. Okay, that's a weird question. Okay, so Kat gave Alice Marion 2 of her old bedspreads. She can afford her own bedspread. She's loaded. She's minted. Right, that bundle's gone. Orange and green bundle next. Oh, now only 5 of these left. 5 of these left now. You saw how quickly the purple ones went. So in this one, you get hydrangea, feathers, damask, chips. No, that's chips. I want to call that pebbles. Oh, tumble and jumble and don't tell me. Oh, I can't remember it. Garland, that's it. Where I used to go dancing. Garlands. 4 left. 4 left going in baskets. That answers from Paul, Alison, Marion, Alison. I just want to say, Kat, sorry. Flying out today, flying out. Right, I'm now going to do these by the half meter. I'll start at the top with Hydrangea. It's nice, isn't it? He doesn't want a shirt out of this one. She's replied to him. 14 units, or meters, did you say? 14 meters of this one. 14 meters of this one. Your chance might be half meter, but obviously you can buy as much as you want. How many colours are in there? 15 different colours in there. Cat's getting overexcited. She's had too much sugar. She had a lot of sugar today. She's got an energy drink. She hasn't had that yet. She's got coffee in a carton. She's had a bowl of sugar with some strawberries in it. And what was the other thing? Oh, no, that was it. Right, okay. Oh, she got carrot sticks and hummus for lunch. And then she went, oh, and Doritos. Other spicy wedges are available. Oh, the green feathers are sold out as well. Sorry. So I've got the orange damask. Oh, all the feathers have sold out. I knew they would. Right, so this is orange damask. Derek's thinking that he can make some lovely waistcoats out of all these. You certainly can. Oh, no, it's again, Vida. We had that yesterday. There's a clicking sound on the noise. No, yesterday it was on Freeview, on the Facebook, and on Sky. Oh, it's not me, it's not my microphone, it's not from us. We've got to work out where it's come from. We'll see who else has got it and see if we can Paul look into it. Beautiful. Chips. I told you, you have little faith. Look, I like this because you've got the formality of the paving here and then it goes all crazy for a while. We've got it in blue, Paul, coming up in blue. $7.49 for half a meter, 100% cotton, machine washable, quilting weight fabric. Did you collect them from the Irish Centre? Beautiful. Then I've got Jumble. Yeah, Jumble. We also used to call this Pebbles, but this Jumble, it's called Jumble. Nice, isn't it? Beautiful colours. Look at the green is intense. Paul's just come out with a statement. I think I need to wear more green. You're not attracted to green then? That means you're fulfilled with whatever green is telling you. Like, you know, like if you're looking for yellow, then you're looking for communication and colour. If you're looking for orange, you're looking for the perfect friendship. Or perfect relationship. See, so you've got, well, that's because you go walking all the time. Life, nature, and renewal, you see, you get that when you go for your walks. Garlands. I think they look like Hannah. You see, there's Hannah, there's her eyebrows. And there's her hair. And then Paul said these are all her different personalities. Well, it depends how much chocolate she's had. You know what I mean? This is like major chocolate. This is like just... But that's people... Yeah, you're the opposite of that. Suzanne says, morning all, a bit late this morning. After answering lots of congratulations messages, I'm going to be a granny. Oh, Suzanne. And then Morag says, John, you're making Chubby, do you mean Hubby? Chubby chuckle with the echo on in living room and kitchen. He's doing the housework. Oh, you've got him well trained. Whilst I make some scones and granddaughter's birthday cake. Oh, it sounds lovely in your house today, Morag. I keep thinking it's Sunday though. I hope I don't forget to get up tomorrow morning. Right, how are we doing with this green bundle then? Green and orange. One left, and remember, if you want the feathers, the green feathers, the only way you can get it now is in that bundle. That one's a bigger bundle at 1, 2, 3 meters in that one. Who are you talking to now? Oh, Carol. If purple is your favorite color, it means you're artistic, an individual, very intuitive. I was gonna say spirituality is purple, yeah. Good judge of character, a visionary. Oh, very nice. Right, okay, moving on. Only one bundle left, that's the pink. This is a big bundle. This is a big, big bundle, this one. So, right, you get bamboo. You get buttons. It's called button something, though, isn't it? Mosaic, that's right. Then you've got garlands. Oh, peony. Peony feathers. Cactus flower. How beautiful is that? This is my favorite. Then you've got moss. And then you've got damask. Isn't it amazing how my brain's kept hold of all those? I know it's only since Tuesday, but... Right, we do have the biggest quantity of stock of this pink one. Oh. Okay, right, there's so many going to baskets, there are six left if you all check out. If you all check out, there are six left. Yeah, we had so many more of these. This one sold out the quickest on launch day. Julie says, the only problem with Kaffe is cutting up his creations, doing them justice. I'll just look and stroke for now. You can do that if you want to, Julie, but I just don't think, oh. Oh, Kat's saying to get a really big embroidery and put it on the wall. Yeah, but she's still got to cut it. Okay, people are buying multiples of this. Now, remember, if you buy multiples, you still only get, like, you know, you'll get, so if you bought two, you get 2 half meters of everything. They don't come joined together. You get a meter, but it's in 2 half meters, if you see what I mean. Right, let's do it by the half meter then. Right, I'm presuming feathers are sold out, so I'm going to push that over there. Right, so I've got pink damask. This is so beautiful. It's a lovely strong pink, that, isn't it? There you go. Beautiful. Two pink. Well, there's actually three pinks in there. Who knew? I don't know, but hang on, let's look at the selfish look. No, because the pale pink's the one colour and then the two reds or the two pinks are there. Maybe it's mottled or maybe you've got a warp and a weft that's a different. Anyway, beautiful, whatever. That's damask in pink. Then I've got moss. Now I haven't seen moss in any other colour so far. It might be moss flower. I know it's moss something, anyway. Oh, moss flower. You might, this reminds you of sweeties. Yeah, Kat, go and have some more sugar. Isn't it lovely? Oh, geodes. She thinks they look like baby geodes. Oh, Suzanne's saying beautiful hot pink sarongs with this one. You might need more than half a meter to make a sarong though, mightn't you? Be a very little sarong. Be like a pelmet. It is so right, but so wrong. That didn't work. Let's just savor that for a bit longer. Oh, I've only got 7 of the pink mega bundle left. I do apologise. Oh, I love this. I love this one so much. Now, this I'm surprised there's any of this left. Oh. Look. Look at the colours. I've got it in blue pool coming up later. Right, there's only 1 metre left of that one. First come, first served. Fastest finger first. Got peonies in red coming up in a minute. Those, right, that will have sold out. Oh no, peonies have sold out. Garlands, this is nice as well, look. This is Angry Hannah. Beautiful, isn't it? Garlands. So I was telling you earlier, Kat was supposed to be at a wedding in Australia this morning. So she watched it. I arrived and she was in her car and I said, get in quick, you'll miss the wedding. She went, I'm already watching it. She was already watching it on her phone. No, we weren't driving. She pulled up in the car park. $7.49. I did a bit of gate chickens. Is that what it's called? Chicken. Gate chicken. I came round the corner. We're behind Greg's, you see, and there's an electronic gate. You have to tap the number in. But the thing's on the other side. It's really weird. So you're driving on the left-hand side of the road, but the thing you have to type your number in is over on the right-hand side of the road. It's the strangest thing. Anyway, the gate was open already as I turned into the road off the main road. The gate was already open. I was like, do I go back to the thing to press it? So I just sped up and went through. No, it was open. It was open. Right, okay. This is orange button mosaic. It's got a purple background. And then it's got the blue thread. Yeah, the blue thread in there. Purple background, blue thread. You've done what? What's Kat trying to say, Paul? Oh, right. I didn't see you, yeah. Okay, then bananas. This is red, Paul. Banana leaf tree. Don't. Yeah, how much of this have got left? No, how's that happened? Okay, we have no idea how, but there's 25 meters. This one, they must have bought another bolt or a couple more bolts. Or they found another bolt somewhere because we definitely didn't have 25 meters left of it on Tuesday. Well, what day did we launch it? It wasn't Tuesday, I was near Monday. No, hang on. What? Yeah, so I did Monday, pavers Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Oh, yeah, Monday. We don't have, let me show you the whole piece. I'll pull the whole piece out like this. Look. Now, Paul, the palm trees will be very big on you. What we love about this is you've got the banana leaves, but then look at the clouds, right? The clouds look like they're in the distance, but they've also got colours within the clouds. Lovely, isn't it? So beautiful. Now, I'm not sure. Oh, no, I've got bananas in blue coming up. That's it. Okay, that's the pink bundle. And how many of the pink bundle have I got left? Okay, so here is the pink bundle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, so 4 meters, right. That's sold out. So that's the only one left in the bundle. You can only get in the bundle. That one sold out. You can only get that in the bundle. That sold out. You can only get that in the bundle. Four meters, right? There's still 7 left. Or was it 7, did you say? Or 5? 7. Oh, 5. There's only 5 left. 5 left. Make sure you check out your basket. So beautiful. We'll leave that one with you. I'll come back to it at the end. Now, the blue, for some reason, the computer has rejected the bundle, which means we've obviously made a mistake somewhere along the line. So the blue is... actually, can I do white first? I'll do the white bundle. This one didn't go into a bundle, so it's just on its own. So this is just by the half meter. So it is a bundle of half meter. We've never seen this before. Button mosaic, it's called in white. They're very popular on pre-order. What are you saying, Paul? No, it's nothing like seashells. Seashell, Johnny Seashell. Bye, Paul. So you got your thread there. Has it got like a teal background? The background of this one's a dark teal. Oh, yeah, it is. You're right. Oh, I think it's like a Tahitian pearl. That's the colour it is. Like Battleship Grey, which has that green tinge. That's the only one we've got in that colourway. So I just thought I'd show you that. Now, going back to this, I don't have a blue bundle. You could create your own blue bundle if you wanted to, because I've got, I've got all these by the half metre, but have I? Oh, okay, right, okay. So I'm going to start with the green button mosaic. And what, this is all, could you stop flying so quickly, please? I'm a little bit worried. Oh, do you see, that's my favourite button one. Definitely, that's my favourite button one. It's a very strong green there. If I was only going to buy this one, or which solid colour would I put it with? I'd want that, I don't think we've got it here. I'd want that colour. It's kind of, wasn't not marine, it's the one down, is it cadet or something like that? Or Copen, yeah. I'm thinking, or I'd go for a bright red, which I haven't got here either. Depends what I'm making, I suppose. Oh, Carol thinks this make a lovely shirt for me. Would you not, eyes not get tired looking at me at that in 4 or 5 hours a day? Would they just get tired? I'll have my shorter hair in next week. God, I can't wait. Oh, exactly the same, but just shorter. No, I'm not going for something different. I've only got a half an hour appointment. Okay, now I've got a moss flower in the blue. Okay, I've got 7.5 meters of this one left. I'm just being totally upfront with you now. There's no point in pretending. I'm just going to tell you when we're short of anything. Beautiful, aren't they? My pink bundle arrived this morning and it's absolutely gorgeous, says Joanne. Does it say Joanne or Joanna? Joanne. Oh, have we got, do we sell Saks Blue, Claire? Do we sell Saks Blue? No, that's the truth. That's a Tony story you're thinking of. We're talking about, just so you know, we're talking about different colour blues. And we all used to work together at Roxburgh, a jewellery company. And we used to have the different stories of why different gemstones were called, what they were and everything. Right, now I've got chips in blue. This is like the bottom of a lovely, glamorous swimming pool. What was that? Hockney did swimming pool pictures, didn't he? Yeah. That's beautiful, isn't it? No. Well, if they're just arriving today, has everyone else's bundle arrived from Monday then? Oh, no, hang on. Not everybody will have, because the book was on pre-order, wasn't it? So some of them will only have gone out. What date is it today? Yeah, so 2 days ago, the book will have gone out. So some of you won't have got your bundles yet, because if you ordered the book as well as the fabric, they were all coming together, weren't they? Lovely, isn't it? Gorgeous. Oh, Adventure in Crafting. That's Sam, isn't it? She's on again soon, I think. She's doing a poncho soon. Oh, I don't know if I'm supposed to tell people. Oh, no, I've seen it on social media. Right, a third of this one, the button mosaic in blue. I've only got 7 metres left now. 7 metres, that's it. The repeat will be there. That's what, Kat? It's obvious. That one. That one. Yeah, but the repeat is this way, not that way. Yeah. It's because when you're cutting it out, you need to, like, what your wallpaper or your pattern matching, you need to know how big the repeat is. I'm hoping my fabric will be waiting for me when I go into school on Monday. Oh, do you have it delivered to school, Derek? It's a bit dangerous, isn't it? Oh, it's because there's someone always there to take the parcel. Clever. Pardon? Okay, Punnum would like to see the orange and the green button fabrics together. So I've got the... Oh, you make the fat quarter skirt. Skirt even. I was about to say I'm featuring that in my next Simply Sewing page. Right, there you go. The orange and the green. So the graphics at the moment are green. Well, let's make a skirt because you cut it into panels, don't you? Whoops. Right, so let's try and do this. And then it was a bit like that. Oh no, I don't want the SL, don't see the selvage. I'm trying to make the... No, Janice is not in today, everybody. Okay, two graphics are in. I'm trying to... Come on, John, my brain won't work. I'm trying to make a panel. There we go. Cat just banged her head. Come on, John. There we go. Oh, it says on the pattern. It's if you've got the pattern, it tells you how much you need. I think it's 12 fat quarters for an adult, so it's 3 meters. 3 meters of fabric. But that if you bought 1.5 of each, be nice, wouldn't it? Depends. Are you going to make all of the outside in the green, not that it matters fabric-wise, and all of the inside in the orange? Because it's reversible, isn't it? Or are you going to make green, orange, green, orange, green, orange, and then put something else inside? Nice. Right, okay, I'm carrying on. Who was it? Punnum, did you say? Okay. Okay, so I've done the green's from this bundle, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, is it? No, the green's from this bundle. Right, now I've got shark's teeth. So now, do you see blue on white or white on blue? I see blue on that one, you see. Why do you put blueberries in the microwave? Oh, okay. Paul's just saying he put blueberries in the microwave yesterday, pressed the start button, the microwave's going round and round, and he saw the blueberries were still on the counter next to his hay fever pills and my red water bottle, no doubt. £7.49, that's lovely. I love it, that in the blue and the white. Now, have I got peonies? We didn't have peony in the red. Paul loves this one for a shirt. Brocade peony in cool, this one's called. We want to know what you're going to make of it, or you're just going to sit and look at it and stroke it. Mm-hmm. Paul says a cushion. Oh, I tell you, we had a conversation yesterday, Paul, about a Chesterfield sofa, and someone in there said Paul wants one, but what colour do you want it in? Oh, you see, we both got it wrong then. They said brown, I said you'd go for a green leather. He wants ox blood, this colour. I used to have oxblood coloured shoes. Right, here we go. Hydrangea. Here you go. Claire said the pattern for the punnum says 8 fat quarters or 2 meters. Oh, no, no, adult, 12 fat quarters or 3 meters of fabric. There you go. Said that's what I said, didn't I? And you, well, Kat did. Kat said the fat quarters. I said the fabric. That's lovely, isn't it, that one? 7.49. No, I'm just, I forgot. Didn't bring my, I don't know where my comb is. Is my comb neck on your kitchen counter as well, Paul? I can't find my comb. Who's put his party in a strange place? What, Liam? Is Liam's hair? Oh, okay. I can't imagine Liam going to the hairdressers. Oh, and also, you know, you have those things that come up on your phone saying so many years ago, like a time hop thing. Yesterday, the film came up of me on set at Rocks & Co. And I'm going like this, and I'm panning the room, and I'm going, there's tall Ian, there's Munch, there's Adam, and they were cleaning the top and everything. Munch looks so, well, they both look so young and skinny, right? So I sent it to Munch, and he went, oh, I was not fat in those days. I was like, you're much fatter now than you were there. It was 5 years ago. Hmm? Oh, no, when I saw it, yeah, but not as skinny. I'll show you the film afterwards. He was really skinny then. Yeah, Adam wasn't even married at that point. Ian was standing at the camera waving. This is lovely. Jumbles in green. Oh, lime. Now, I love it because it's got that lovely soft grey in the background, doesn't it? This is when, remember earlier when we had Daisical, Whimsy Daisical in the first hour, and we said, well, that's very Kaffe, isn't it? Okay, let's move on to banana plant in blue. I've only got 11 and a half meters of this one. You see, that's what makes me think that we must have found another bolt of the red one. Oh, I'm seeing swimming trunks. Or board shorts. What's they called? Board shorts. Yeah, board shorts. Lovely, isn't it? Again, the clouds in the background, the big banana leaves. You want to see this with the red version? Okay. It's going to be quite a stark difference. Oh. They're definitely making these stickers with less glue on them. There you go. No, I love the blue. I love the blue. Which one, the blue or the red? Oh, the blue, let me take the red away then. Yeah, there you go. Colours in there are beautiful, aren't they? Lots going into basket. Please make sure you check out if you want to guarantee it's yours. Oh no, we had so many sellouts this hour. Please be careful, because putting it in your basket doesn't mean it's yours. If other people check out, and that, like, how many did you say this? There were 10 or something. Say there were 10, and you've put it in your basket, then 10 people buy a meter each. They'll get it. You won't get it, you see. And I'm not being horrible. I'm just telling you the logistics. Them's the rules, as Kat says. Right, now, blue feathers. It's not sold out. Oh, it has sold out. Blue garlands. Any of these fabrics make a gorgeous simple scarf or waistcoat sensational. They would indeed, Julie. No, I've got one more. Oh no, cactus. Cactus flower in blue is sold out. Well, we should also, so the green bundle sold out, the purple bundle sold out. I've still got the red bundle. Have I got any fabrics that we need to just warn people on? Oh yeah. Well done, Paul. Moss flower in pink is, yeah, moss flower in pink. I need to warn you about that one. There's only 5 meters of this one left. I'll put that one in quickly. And I've just read that one out. Someone swapped my cushions over while I've not been looking. It's not come through to me, that. Is that a message with you? Okay. Oh, who's that from? Jess, no issues this end, I'm afraid. Can you check? You need to check yours, I'm afraid. Refresh your box, whatever they say. Okay, so that's folded up. That goes in there. And then I need to show you cactus flower. The other colour cactus flower sold out. This is the only one I've got left now. This is the one Paul wants the shirt in. Do you want short sleeves or long sleeve, Paul? Now he's having matching shorts. He wants a shirt and short combo. Because everyone else would have run out. I'm just seeing Paul in skinny jeans. And what shoes were you wearing? Seven meets this one left. Okay, now I just need to remind you of the pink bundle. Hang on. Yeah, we had more stock of this one. If we had the same amount of stock of this the others, it would have gone. Right, I'm a bit confused. Right, okay, so you get your moss. Now, this is sold out. The peony is sold out by the half meter. I'm going to wait for Paul to come around. Peony, right. This is sold out, cactus flower in the pink. We've got damask. Feathers are sold out in the pink and red. We've got garland and we've got that. Hang on, is that the right amount? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, and that, is it this one as well? Is it that button one there? Yeah. So, 4 left. That's all I've got of this bundle. 4 left. And you can't get that one, that one, that one on its own. I can't recreate this bundle for you. And you can't recreate it. No? Who knows? I mean, we may never get it again. I don't know. I don't know what the plans are with the buying department. Right. Oh, I've got complimentary fabrics. Do you want me to run through those or the book first? I'll do the complimentary. Complimentary as in meaning going with, not free. Dark grey. Yeah, dark colours with Kaffe, I think it look lovely. Yeah. Well, mind you, look at those two together. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? For a bag. Dark grey. No, we've got one called Slate Pawn. It's very pale. Just so you know. It's lovely. Now, this isn't Kaffe. This is our Rose and Hubble stock core fabric. Then I've got magenta. Let's go with my shirt, this one. Look. This is not the colour of your car. Your car is like bubblegum pink. £3.49 for half metres, 44 inches wide, machine washable, 100% cotton. Yeah, but the fat quarter skirt, I can't even say it. The fat quarter skirt is reversible. So you want to make the back as interesting as the front, really, don't you? Black. What am I making? Yeah, shadow puppets. Don't know why. £3.49 for half a metre. They had us on the other day. I got a photo from our sister channel, Gemporia, going, we're watching. Rachel. Oh, did you? Yeah, now, on your telly, this looks blue. In real life, it's amethyst purple, even though we called it purple. $3.49. Who? Oh, right. So Kat, the people who got married, they're called what? Ethan and Amy, who got married in Australia this morning. They're now having their wedding breakfast, and they've taken a picture of the plate of food to say to Kat, this is what you could have had if you were here. That's nice. Oh. Steak and mashed potato. What's the vegetarian option? Can you ask? Can I ask if Kaffe's design wall is on the show already been? Would really like to see how big it is. Thank you, April. I can tell you how big it is. It's 1.5 metres long. I'll just get Kat to check this. By, I think, 4. Says on the front of the box. Oh, which box have you got? Oh, we got them here. April, we're going to look for you. I think it's 1.5 metres long by, well, it's that wide, isn't it? 55. I'd say it was 55, but here you go. I won't touch it. Just throw it, Kat, and then I'll... She's got a mask on, don't worry. Right, April, this is how big it is. Right, so it's this wide. Oh, no, that's 44 inches wide, I'd say. On the mannequin, someone's moved it. There it is. Yeah, come over and then I'll stand up with it a minute for April. So it's, 44 inches wide. And I'm sure it's 1.5 metres in length. Yeah, it's 1.5 metres long, April, and 44 inches wide. So you can see here, look. That's how big it is. Can you see that? Does that give you any idea of how big it is? Oh, yeah, there you go. We'll put it through. Can we put it through the graphics, Kat? Is that allowed? We're going to put it through the graphics for. Oh, there's only 9 left. £26.99, 9 left. Oh, it says 1.5 metres on there, grey flannel fabric. Hope that helps, April. Right, okay, right, so I've done purple. Now I've got like green. Now I'm thinking it might be fur. Not fur as in fur, but fur, yeah. £3.49. Oh, thank you very much, says April. You're more than welcome. If we can help, we will do, you see. We're live, we're interactive, we're coming for you from the Midlands. That doesn't sound very good, does it? Are we still in West Midlands here? We're only just in the Redditch, because I follow at the roundabout there, the sign saying welcome to Redditch. So I presume we're only just into the Redditch area. Here you go. Whereabouts, Kat? Well, I haven't. Oh, yeah. Oh, are they the ones from Stratford? Have they got wood carvings for sale? Yeah. White. That road, that bit where you come, there's a bit where we come into work from, if you come from Stratford area. Do you come that way? You must come the opposite way to me though, surely. Oh, well anyway, there's a bit where you come off the A435 and you come down to whatever the road to Redditch is here. And there's one of those that you come down, right? They never, on icy days, they don't grit it or anything. And it's like that, it's one of those. It's like going up into one of those car parks. We have to keep going up and up and up around like that. Navy blue. Oh, is it navy blue? This is navy. Very quickly, look at the time. These aren't Kaffe fabrics. These are our Rose and Hubble core fabrics. Always cut off the bolt for you. You can have as much as you like. Somebody's what? Somebody's just bought 14 metres of white. That's what you can do. Mm-hmm. Treat yourself. Right, okay, now quickly, I've got some threads and I've got the book. I'll do the threads first. Now, we're limited on that. These were created by, look at all the designers, all the quilters on here, right? So you've got Joe Avery, Lucy Brennan, Carolyn Forster, Lynn Goldsworthy, Kerry Green, Katie Jones, Florence Knapp, Karen Lewis, Lou Orton, Jenny Smith. They were all given a colour to be in charge of. Lucy was in charge of the orange. That's a... £88.99. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. First of all, told you the price. You get black, white, you get your silver, grey. Oh, you get two blacks. Is that two blacks in there? Oh, no, they're different colours. But anyway, the pink is variegated. You've got orange, fuchsia, lavender, bright blue, sky blue, lime green, lemon, and then your piecing colours. Right, each of those is 1,200 metres long, 1,300 metres long, 741 a spool, 57 pence per 100 metres. And if you think of other threads you can buy out there, they're £1.90 for 100 metres, aren't they? Not cotton. So it's not expensive. It's 50 weight, isn't it, this? 50 weight, gorgeous. 12 beautiful colours, 50 weight, 100% Egyptian cotton, made in Italy, but there's only 9 left. Oh, didn't you just say 9? Oh, 4! Was it 9 when we started? I'm sure you said 9. 4. 4 left. Rightio. Then very quickly, before I go, book available, ready to send out to you immediately. And also, so the people who bought the fabric on Monday, they've received their fabric already. So think how quickly this could be with you. Obviously, we're going into the weekend now. No, we are in the weekend now. And I don't know if the warehouse do. I don't know if they work weekends or not. I know nothing. Oh, no, hang on. Shh. Paul, you missed it. I was listening. No, they're not in. Not in. This should be £30. Cat got into trouble because it's supposed to be £30. She said having to work with me, you see. £27.90. Right, look, we need to get on because it's 11 o'clock. Jude is up next. Now, what are we making, Paul? These? Now, I've got to talk to Kat about this, but we're going to be making those from a gorgeous little book straight after this break.
Keep up to date with what's on Sewing Street and Yarn Lane, as well as all the latest news and special offers by signing up to our email newsletters. For Sewing Street, head on over to www.sewingstreet.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and you're done. It's exactly the same for Yarn Lane. Head on over to www.yarnlane.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and that's it. You are now subscribed to both Sewing Street's and Yarn Lane's email newsletters, so you'll never miss out on the latest news and special offers ever again.
Have you heard about all of the different ways you can shop with Sewing Street and Yarn Lane? You can either shop on our websites, sewingstreet.com and yarnlane.com. You can also order by phone by calling our friendly UK customer service team. For Sewing Street, call 0800 001 4433 and for Yarn Lane, call 0800 4700 600. And don't forget about the Sewing Street app. Here you can shop all of the Sewing Street products as well as watch the live shows from anywhere. You can download the app onto your smartphone or your tablet by simply searching Sewing Street in your app store. And one final thing, no matter how many times you check out on Sewing Street or Yarn Lane in one day, you will only pay one postage and packaging. Happy shopping!
Hello everyone, I'm Delphine Brooks. It's so great to be here and part of the Sewing Street family. I'm local, I'm only down the road in Warwickshire. I started sewing many years ago when I was very young, doing lots of art and painting, and eventually I went into textiles and I really enjoyed doing the two together. I then had a bit of a break. Something you don't know about me maybe is that I spent many years in the Royal Air Force and eventually in the police as well. And then I went full circle and I've come back to my happy place of sewing, and which I really enjoy. My best sewing tip is measure twice and cut once. I have chipped up a couple of times by not measuring properly, and I do always regret it. So now I always measure twice, cut once. Anyway, I really hope to be with you again soon, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. Thank you.
In need of a crafting fix? There are so many ways you can watch Sewing Street and Yarn Lane. Sewing Street is live from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. every day on Freeview 72 and Sky 670. Alternatively, if you want to watch us on a tablet or on the move, you can tune in on our YouTube channel, the Sewing Street app, or the websites at www.sewingstreet.com and www.yarnlane.com. You can watch past shows on Sky 670 from 1 p.m. every day, as well as our YouTube channel, the app, and our website. Yarn Lane is on from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Visit our programme guide to find out when and what's on, so you never have to spend a minute without us.
If you'd like to get in touch with us during our live show and send in any messages or any questions, then you can do it on studio@sewingstreet.com. Alternatively, you can message us on our official Facebook page.
Keep up to date with what's on Sewing Street and Yarn Lane, as well as all the latest news and special offers by signing up to our email newsletters. For Sewing Street, head on over to www.sewingstreet.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and you're done. It's exactly the same for Yarn Lane. Head on over to www.yarnlane.com. Scroll down to the bottom of the homepage, type in your email address, click the envelope, and that's it. You are now subscribed to both Sewing Street's and Yarn Lane's email newsletters, so you'll never miss out on the latest news and special offers ever again.
If you'd like to get in touch with us during our live show and send in any messages or any questions, then you can do it on studio@sewingstreet.com. Alternatively, you can message us on our official Facebook page.
So I just said to Kat, so when we go home in a minute, she went, you're not going anywhere, John. You've got 2 hours to go yet. I'm not that I'm complaining. I just was Yeah. Anyway, look, aren't these cute? Aren't these cute? Now, these are in one of these books I'm going to show you now. Which one, though? Which one? I'm not telling you. Right, they're gorgeous. Jude's here. She's going to make those for us in a second, but I'm just going to take you to everything I've got here. So I'm going to start off with weekend sewing. It is the weekend, and it's Annie's sewing. Whenever we bring you Annie's quilting, Annie's sewing's book, they always, always, always fly out. Oh, hang on. I've just seen some of those in the dressing room. Oh, were they? No, I haven't seen those then. They're from a different project. Right, so you've got 20 plus quick and so, right, here we go. Oh, I've obviously had this before it's opened up. Flower pocket pin cushion. So cozies. Why do your buttons need to stay warm? Oh, I'll just tell you what's in there, I suppose. Duh. Sewing machine cover. Sewing machine organizer pad. Oh. Now, hang on now, didn't we? We had one of these last week, didn't we? Dawn Taylor did one of those, didn't she? Ironing board caddy. Pin cushion. Tricolour or tricolour table topper. Oh, I see. It's the nine patch within the square in a square design. Daisy Fields. That's what I'm calling Maisie now, Daisy. Because she's called Maisie Delilah. So I'm going to call her Daisy. Okay. Oh, no, they're the ones in the dressing room. You're right, they weren't mug rugs. Not much room for your biscuit on there, though, is there, really? To be honest. I'm not supposed to be having any biscuits, am I? And then all your templates. Then you got pot holders, which we know Hannah loves. I don't understand these. Microwave cozies. Fresh bread bag. This morning, the microwave here is much stronger than my microwave, and I did my porridge. Oh! I did my porridge this morning, the bowl was boiling. Right, three baskets, so useful and decorative at any... Oh, lovely. That's what we're doing. I don't know why they've got to... Oh, so you can store your jelly rolls and your fat quarters, everything in there. That's a butterfly. It's a flower. We'll come back to that in a minute. Oh, okay, so this is a bit, right, so my producer is what's supposed to be inspiring. Have a look at the book, but don't buy it, she said. Have a look at it and don't buy it. That's what Kat, my producer, just said to me. So if the management are watching, it's Saturday. Flower eyeglass case, change purse, I need one of those. I've got an old sunglasses case. Oh, now Kat says buy it if you want, but she's advising you not to buy it yet. Not to buy. 20 plus projects for $9.99. We have another book called More Weekend Sewing. 25 in this one. 25 plus projects in this one. Oh, and this one's $8.99. Now, Kat, are you... Right, and she's still going to say, look at it, but don't buy it. Patchwork baskets. This book's not been opened before. I've not broken the spine on this one. Quilted drawstring bag. Oh, I have had this one before. You see, they annoy me because I'd want to eat those. You can't eat them, they're wool. Birds of a feather pin cushions on wheels. Pin cushion mug topper. Now, please be careful. Don't put that on a boiling hot cup of tea. Armchair sewing organizer. Paul's got one of these. It's not for sewing though. He keeps his what's it called? Remote. His remote and his bar of chocolate. Magazine. No, the magazine's around the other side. Do they still make that, Paul? Sleep. Okay, Kat wants one of these for her bed. Well, first of all, you shouldn't have your phone by the bed, Kat. Oh, what? Okay, Kat keeps a phone under a pillow. Anyway, I'm moving on. Flowers on the vine. Fabric bowl and pan covers. And we worried about her sugar intake. We should be more worried about the phone under the pillow. Eat cake. Have your cake and eat it too. More pot holders. Insulated beverage cozy. Well, yeah. Rose twirl. 25 plus projects in here. And, oh, hang on, there's an elephant. I didn't see an elephant, did you? Oh, there he is. Right, okay, we're saying don't buy this. $8.99, do not buy it, because today you can buy both for $16.99. Well, one was $9.99, that was $8.99. That's 10 and 9, £19. You're saving, what, £2, are you? Over 10%? Over 10%. Okay, limited on the bundle already. You can buy it now. You can buy it now. Cat say, buy it now. Buy it now. Just buy it. Compra logo. That's Portuguese for just buy it. Oh, did you? What's the matter? Norma, there's no telling. I'll have a word with her after in the break. They are though, Paul. $16.99. Right, come on, we've got to get on. Got to go on. Got to do some sewing. Right, bundles. Now. I need to explain. So it with the bundle, we've got here is for all sorts of projects within the book, right? So now I need to tell you, for these floral baskets, we've got three different sizes. You can't make the biggest one like we have because you've only got a fat quarter of the fabric. So we put fabrics in the bundles to create projects. You can make the smaller one, and if you patch your fat quarters, you can make the middle size one, but you're gonna need more fabric it is for the big one. This is middle, and that's small. So they're not small, and you know, but that is the small one, and that is the middle one. And then the other one you'll see in a minute on Jude's desk is like this. Huge, right? So you've got, between this, you've got 45 plus projects in here. So you don't have to make what the project we're doing today. We're just doing one to show you. So these are gorgeous little bundles for you to create what you want to. Okay, this one's what the sample. So what we're doing in this bundle is we are putting 1.5 meters of cream fabric. I think this is natural seeded. We'll just double check. Feels like the natural seeded. Then you get a fat quarter. I didn't say Oldenburg, did I? Did I say Oldenburg? No, right. The thing fell off the table. Starville fell off the table. Then you get three fat quarters. I think I love these. I love these prints. This is one I think should be a skirt in West Side Story. Oh, okay. Now, if you like these fabrics, you want to buy more to make the bigger one, type in what? Posy. POSY. Oh yeah, like on the graphics, put Posy in and you better see these fabrics. You can buy them by the 1/2 meter. Okay, so that's that bundle. How much was it? Oh, $19.99. Nice little bundle to have anyway. The one that's being made in the demo is this one. So there's 1.5 meters of your natural seeded cotton. This lovely fat cotton, that's a batik. Nice. Then you've got your, are they all batiks? Yeah. This is the batik bundle. Does it say that on the thing? Oh, barley hand prints, there you go. So this, you get the three fat quarters, 1.5 meters of cream, $19.99. Then I've got a blue version. Oh, actually, this blue version is more affordable. So you get 1.5 meters of the cream, natural seeded cotton. Then you get a fat quarter of the blue floral. You get a fat quarter of the white floral with blue. This is misty blue, which is green. That's called misty blue. I know it's misty blue. What they've done is they thought they've put a blue one in and it's a green one. Anyway, that's that bundle. Very quickly, while I'm here, the Styleville was our early bird special this morning. Jude made hers with Styleville. She's not making the sample with Styleville. That's another way to do it, but this is the Styleville. Styleville will create this body behind your fabric and everything like that. It comes, this is how it comes. Half a metre by 72 centimetres. You're saving a pound today if you buy it. That price will go back up tomorrow. £5.99. Now, if you buy two, they don't come joined together. They will come in separate little bundles. Okay? Then I've got, I'm just going to do the buttons and the embroidery. Then I've done everything then. So I've got glitter, mother of pearly, hologrammy. Can you see that? Sparkly. Iridescent, that's the word I was looking for. Thank you, Paul. Beautiful. £2.49. Dispersion. Then I've got some green buttons. Now, on the website, this looks like you're getting a great big button like this. You get three of these. 20 millimetre, pack of three for £2.49. And then, as you see, the butterfly, which I haven't got on my bag, has got its, you know, like it's, what do you call it when a plane goes, oh, yesterday, Mikey, my nephew, who's learning to fly, right, to be a pilot, yesterday was his last solo flight in a little aeroplane. He goes to big aeroplanes, and he said, I'm going to come and fly over your house, Uncle John. So I said, when will you be here? He said, in 5 minutes' time. So I went out, only had my shirt sleeves and my trousers and my flip-flops on. I stood there like this, freezing, going, where are you? Went, oh, I've been and gone. I was like, oh, thanks. I've stood here for 20 minutes waiting for you. Anyway, skein of embroidery thread. So he moves on to big aeroplanes now. £1.49. We've got other embroidery threads on the website if you want to choose a different colour. Right. Oh, okay. Now, we're going to quickly, very quickly, if you do want to make the bigger projects, what we've done is we've got these by the half metre as well. So which colour would you like to start with? Olive? I'd call that yellow, wouldn't you? This is obviously only a fat quarter, but just so you see the pattern. Oh, actually, I'll tell you what, if I hold this out like this, this is how it normally looks by the half metre. There you go. I'll have a drink of water in a second. £6.99 for half a metre. Posy bright, big roses on olive. If you want to make more of them, you want more of that fabric, that's beautiful. If your olives are that colour, I'd be a bit worried, wouldn't you? On cream, which is the one I always talk about, West Side Story. I'll just open it that far. £6.99 on cream, big roses on cream. And then last but not least, big roses on orange. It's got a very 50s vibe to it, this fabric, isn't it? Oh, they call that rust, not orange, rust. Don't forget to check out your bundle of books because there's lots of you got it in your basket. Right, Jude, what did you get from Greg's?
Oh, chocolate croissant.
Did you get coffee with it?
Hot chocolate.
Oh, hot chocolate.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Lovely.
Okay, that, and what did Sarah get?
Sarah, sausage sandwich and a hot choc.
Oh.
Yeah, delish.
Oh. Right, okay, let's make these because they're not difficult, are they?
Not at all.
Okay.
Simple, simple. It says on the thing, it says like weekend job or whatever
weekend
as well.
Weekend makes.
Yeah, weekend makes. So even easier if you've got nothing to do, rainy day, whatever. Get yourself one of these.
Okay, now you haven't used the Styleville, have you? You've used H640.
Yes.
Yours, haven't you?
Yeah.
Just to see what, you might have H640 at home or something, and you might want to see how it works.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So where do we start? What do we do? What does it tell us to do in the book?
So to begin with, you cut all your pieces out, and with the three sizes, I was surprised at how big they were actually.
Yeah, when you turned up with that one this morning, I was really shocked.
Massive,
you can take
isn't
it down
it?
And put it on the table if you want.
Absolutely massive. I don't really
Which
know what you're
Which is
you
why
we're
saying that won't, you wouldn't be able to make that out of this bundle. You'd
no.
have enough of the cream fabric, but you wouldn't have enough of the lining fabric.
It's like a washing basket, isn't it?
Mm.
Massive. But yeah, lovely.
Okay.
I do like this padding though, it's nice.
Yeah, the Styleville, it's very
yeah.
nice, isn't it?
Really good, like structure.
So, which size are you making?
I have this is the medium, is it?
Is it medium or is it the small?
This is the small, this one
that's
here.
The small, so that's what we're doing. Yeah.
Yeah, and then I've got a medium just to show as well.
Oh, okay, perfect. Lovely.
But yeah, really, really, really easy. If anyone's ever made like little bags or even like makeup bags and things like that before, it's pretty much a really like simple shape.
Is
just
there
a
pattern in the book, or does it tell you what sizes to cut out?
It tells you what sizes to cut, but there is a little pattern to trace, and I just traced them and cut them out on my own. So I didn't
have
to,
for the applique, you got a template for the applique, but for the actual...
But because it's just a rectangle, you don't need to... But perfect. With these ones, I just traced around it so I didn't have to mess the book up.
Yeah, okay. What's the one next to it then?
That says floral fabric baskets. Oh, it's the butterfly antenna. But I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory. Oh, it's just two lines, isn't it? Bit rigged.
Okay, so you cut out, it tells you to cut out.
Yep, so the small one, just so you can kind of get an idea of size, is 10 inches by 14.
Okay.
So 10 by 14. Right. So it's pretty big still. Mm. And then what you do is, once you've got it all cut, so you want to lay it on your wadding as well, so whichever one you want to use. And you do this the same process for all three baskets. So the first one, the small one is 10 by 14, the middle one is 12 by 17, and the large one is 16 by 22.
Okay.
So it's pretty simple. And then to get this nice like quilted effect, just a bit more texture and squidginess, all you do is sew straight lines up and down.
So it's only the two, it's the two layers, it's your outer fabric plus your wadding. There's no lining anything in there yet.
No, just those two. And it says to do it an inch apart, but if you wanted to do it, and I suppose you could do any pattern really.
Yeah, you could cross hatch or anything, or swirly lines or anything.
If you're really into, quilting,
I suppose the more stitching, if you did cross hatch, it's going to give it more, because you've got twice as many lines, it's going to make it more sturdy, isn't it? Really?
Yeah, definitely. Especially if you're using something like this, it's a bit more loose. And then with each of the ones, each of the baskets, to make them 3D, so they'll stand up. So they're like really secure, aren't they? Stand up and dead easy, won't fall over. It's 3 inches, 3 inch square from each one.
Okay.
So you would just do that. So then you put your two, obviously you do two of each, back and a front. And once you've got it all nice and quilted and you've cut it out, so it's like a big T.
Yeah.
You would sew down this line, this line and this line.
Okay, so what seam allowance is it?
It's quarter of an inch again, so you don't have to worry about like adding anything or whatever.
I've only got 8 of the bundle of books left, just so you know. If you want to save your 10%, get both books, only 8 of those there. You can buy them individually if you want to, but obviously you save your 10% if you buy both together. Yeah, lots of people already have Annie's quilted books home, but get the new one. But the new one's cheaper, isn't it, for some reason? Don't know why.
Nice and simple. And then to get the 3D effect, so you do, you've got your T there.
Yeah.
You kind of just split it and whoop-ah.
Create another seam.
Yeah. So put the two cut ends together to make that flat.
And okay, now, before you go on, you've got 8, so you haven't done anything wrong, don't worry. With your 8640, we're all used to 8640, but if somebody's not used the Styleville before, does it get bulky doing the seams, especially this bit when you've suddenly got your, when you're doing your box bottom there?
It was actually fine for my machine at home. It was completely fine.
And you've just got a normal, straightforward domestic machine?
Mine's not electronic or anything like this. Mine's completely just...
Simple.
Yeah, it was absolutely fine. The only thing is, it sheds quite a bit.
The Styleville.
Yeah, it created like a little bit of dust. But once you just get your little brush out for your machine, it's absolutely fine.
So it's not going to struggle. Your machine's not going to struggle.
Didn't break any needles, so I was all right.
Yeah.
Thankfully.
Yeah, you break a lot of needles then.
Yeah, because I tend to do a lot of layers when I'm sewing, with my own things. And then just the same on the other side.
Uh-huh.
And this is when it comes to an actual shape.
Yeah, it will be interesting to see how, I don't want to use the word sturdy, what's the word I'm looking for? How different it is with the H640 as it is with the Styleville.
Sturdy wise. But it's, I mean, even just on its own without a lining or anything, it's holding itself well.
Exactly. Okay.
So I've done the same with the middle one as well, so you can kind of see there the difference in size. And then you just turn it inside out so you can kind of see.
Yeah.
Nice and simple. But before you've done that, it is a little bit easier. You can do it afterwards, but so you're not struggling with all the extra fabric and things, it's a little bit easier if you want to do your applique before.
Right, okay.
Which I did, but, you know.
And now, so the applique templates are in the book, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah. So there's the petal for the flower and the leaf.
Okay.
It says to do 6 petals, but I mean, if you wanted to do less, if you want to do more, you could layer them up and do whatever you wanted, really.
Yeah.
And this, I feel like this fabric's lovely for that as well.
Yeah.
Super simple to make these. They're just fiddly because it's just little bits. But again, you just, it's, and this book's so easy to follow because there's little
drawings.
Drawings all the way along.
Uh huh.
Which I sometimes feel is a bit easier.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you not think?
Yeah. So you cut, how many, excuse me, how many did you cut out?
Six petals. Well, 12, including back and front. Yeah. But you sew them as if, like I've got the leaf here to show. So you would put your 2 layers.
Oh, they've got Stelville in them as well.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, in the petals and everything. Yeah. So they're really nice and squidgy.
Everything's squidgy, yeah.
Mm. So yeah, it'll hold its shape a lot longer as well.
Yeah.
So you put your 2 layers. I've just kept it folded over.
Yeah,
just
yeah.
Waste less fabric, and then you salve it on the back.
Right.
So it doesn't matter which way it is. Draw around your template. I don't know if you'll be able to see. It's quite faint.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With the friction pen again.
Right.
But with the petal, the only difference is your opening would be at the bottom.
Right.
So then you can tuck it under and you won't see, just in case these are a little bit more flappy and things
like
that.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
But with the leaf, what it tells you to do, which I didn't actually do for them because I read it wrong the first time.
Oh.
I know, tut tut. Is cut a little hole there so that you can see.
Yeah.
Once you've sewn round, you can kind of flip it out.
Oh,
it'll be,
so on the petal, you leave the end open to bag it through.
Yeah.
But on the leaf, you split the back.
And yeah.
So you've sewn all the way around. You don't leave a gap.
Which is so much easier to do. Because I've never ever done it that way before.
Oh, have you not?
No.
I suppose you can do it like that when you know that the back is going against something else. Because does it tell you to sew the gap up?
It does, yeah. Okay. It tells you to do that. But, I mean, you wouldn't have to if you were sewing it flat,
no, exactly.
Really.
No,
I wouldn't bother, to
okay.
be honest.
So you've put your 2 layers of your fabric and your Stelville underneath.
Yep. So okay. Then once you've flipped it out, it does say to press as well, just and then you get all the edges nice.
Is it easy to sew through with the Stelville in it?
Yeah. Because it's quite thin as well, and it compresses, and especially once you've ironed it,
yeah.
It kind of bastes itself to the fabric anyway.
Yeah.
So then it does. It even tells you like so position where to like position your flower and things like that. But of course, you can do it where you want.
Yeah, of course, yeah. But it's easier to do that now rather than later on.
It is, yeah.
I mean, not now. Before you even sew it together.
Before you've sewn anything together, but yeah, just demonstration. But yeah, so it would look like this, and I suppose you could hand sew it if you wanted to, but I've found it just easier to just go up on the machine, nice and quick.
Straight up through the middle of the petal. So you're creating a middle of the petal.
Yeah.
Oh, it's nice, it's 3D, it's going to be moveable.
Yeah.
Because if you hand stitch it around the edge, it's going to be flat, isn't it?
Yeah.
Whereas doing it your way, it's going to have movement.
Just a bit of movement, yeah.
Yeah. Perfect.
So you try and get your machine in there somehow.
Oh, yeah. But if you're doing it on the flat before you've done
so
it,
much
then
easier.
You've not got this problem.
Yeah. And I mean, it even sews through the layers so easy as well. Like, you don't have to worry about any of that.
Uh-huh.
Have a look.
They are pretty projects, aren't they, Christine?
There's so many nice ones.
Excuse me, just wiping my nose on my cuff.
So easy.
Yeah.
And then with the flower, I'm going to use these nice little buttons. And you can just place that in the middle. And it just
Yes, yeah.
A little bit of sparkle.
Yeah.
And everything like that.
Lovely.
So you can use your, again, if you wanted to do this before, so it's a little bit easier for you.
Yeah.
And then you're not faffing on like I am now. Uh-huh.
And do you use your embroidery thread to stitch the buttons on with them?
I do. I just feel like it's a bit thicker.
Oh, no, because you can see they're not on a shank. You can see it, so it's going to give it even more depth. With like the Kaffe buttons earlier, you could see all the threads through the middle and everything.
Yeah.
It's quite nice.
Mm. Got a little knot there.
Oh.
Blow my neck.
So we put the embroidery thread is here because also on the butterfly one, she's got...
Yes. A little, I don't know what you call
it. No, I don't know what you call it either.
Like a bee kind of thing, isn't it? The buzzy bee. Yeah. I don't know.
There it is on the big bag there.
Yeah. So this is so, I mean, if you're not even good at sewing, then you know how to sew a button on.
Yeah, exactly.
Surely. By now.
Paul won't be able to do it, he said.
He'll have to practice.
No, he'll take it around to his mum's. His mum sews for the WI and everything.
Really?
She's got her own little company going. She's got her own Instagram page.
Oh, she?
Yeah.
Oh, well done, huh?
Delightful Delicate, it's called. Oh, and little Paul's looking for... This isn't meant at you. Little Paul's looking for a girlfriend. The underscore Duke 1111.
There we go.
I've known little Paul for how many years, Paul? 9, 8 years? He's been like that since I've met him.
Little Paul.
Well, it's only because where we worked before, there was a big Chris and little Chris.
Oh,
and then
right.
Paul arrived. That had to be a big Paul and a little Paul.
Oh.
Except there was no big Paul.
There we go. Simple.
Okay, lovely.
And then you just do the exact same. So I'll show you how to do this leaf.
Yeah.
So once you've got it all layered up, and I find it easy to cut the slip before, and then you're not cutting through two layers just in case. No,
exactly.
So. And it's a nice, like, smooth curve as well, so you're not faffing on.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard to do curves, isn't it?
Bundle of books are sold out. They are still available individually, but the bundle's sold out. The one you're working from is from Weekend Sewing, not More Weekend Sewing.
There we go. So once you've cut round, super easy to flip. Because you can get your actual fingers in there. With the petals, it's quite difficult. You might need like some scissors or a little pokey tool or something to try.
Or chopstick.
Yeah, good idea.
It would be lovely to do a chubby bee at the end of the sky trail. That's what it's called, sky trail. Thank you, Julie. That's not a Bond film. It's the one I didn't do. Isn't it? Oh no, it was after me. No, the one I did. No, the one I didn't do was the Ice Palace one. What was that one called? I did the costumes for James Bond films. That's what I used to do.
Did you?
So I did GoldenEye, The World's Not Enough, and Tomorrow Never Dies, and then left. Then I did Tomb Raider, and then I went to work at This Morning, so, and with the plan to go back to do the one with the ice. And then that was it. Yeah.
As if. That's so cool, isn't it? There we go. So you can just position these where you want.
Yeah.
And I just did the exact same thing, just sewing like a little stem.
Yeah.
Again, if you wanted to hand stitch it, go for it. And it is easier again once when you don't have all this.
Yeah. But you can also embroider like a little stalk or something like that, couldn't you?
Between
or whatever. It's up to you.
Yeah. And I suppose like it's just what you're into, isn't it?
Exactly.
If you like doing embroidery. Then go for it.
Yeah.
I love embroidery.
So what kind of embroidery did you do then? Because you said you did it as part of your course.
Yeah, it was more just like different techniques and stuff like that to begin with. That's what they taught us.
Uh-huh.
And then I got into like beading and stuff like that. Loved beading. Mm. Just so time consuming.
Oh, yeah.
But I love it. And then like couching and things like that.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, different things.
Yeah.
So I did... For my third year, I did like a chair inspired by like cacti and stuff like that. So I made like really long, like 3D beads, like with wire and stuff. So all the back of it was like
uncomfortable to sit
spiky.
On.
It was all. It was just on the back. It was fine. It's in my bedroom now.
Yeah, but then you put it on the back, and then that bit goes against the wall.
I know.
You have to have it facing the wrong way to see your artwork.
Oh, they want you to do all kinds of crazy ideas at uni. She's wanting me to upholster a canoe and all kinds of things.
Oh wow, that would be brilliant.
But then my tutor said, "Well, I've got a canoe, but you can't have it." I was like, "Where am I going to get a canoe from?"
Yeah.
Car boot sale.
This course has to be brought back, doesn't it? We have to start a campaign to get this course back.
Honestly, brilliant. I would go again. It was amazing.
No, you're not allowed to do that.
I know. Spent too much money there.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay.
Simples. Dead easy.
Right, then how do you make the lining then?
The lining?
What do you make one?
It's the exact same pattern as the basket.
Oh, okay.
So you're doing the exact same. So if you're doing the small one, you do the same measurements as the small, obviously. And it's the same 3-inch square from the corner. Yep. So with this one, I've gone for the nice blue.
Uh-huh.
And I've already sewn it. You just do the exact same where you sew it down the three edges, leaving the two little cutouts.
Okay.
And then sew your seam along the side as well. Does that make sense?
I can't see. Oh, yeah, the box bottom, yeah.
Yeah.
Have you left a turning hole?
I have.
Oh, okay. Did it tell you to do that in the
instructions? It does, yeah. I'm not sure if it says to do it at the bottom, but I always prefer to do it at the side. I just find it a little bit easier to sew once it's all in there, just so you can get your hands in.
I also think that it depends what you use for. When you do bags, I think you put your hand into the bottom to find things like your keys and everything the whole time, whereas if it's on the side, it's less likely to catch, isn't it?
Yeah, that's true, to be honest.
What Kat's saying is what you could do is if you are making the small one, you had more fabric than me.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering, because you could almost patch your line. Oh, no, if you're making the medium one, you could patch your lining, have one on one side and one on the other side, because we're just saying about if they didn't want to buy more fabric, just make it in the bundle. Yeah, okay.
It's a good, like, scrap fabric project and things like that as well, especially for the little butterflies and things.
Yeah.
Also, with the basket, the handles and all of them, which also have the padding in them.
Okay.
But you don't have to put padding in if you don't want to.
Okay, how did you make the... Now, hang on then. So do the handles have to be made before you do the lining? Or to put on before you do the lining?
Yeah, I just pinned them at the same time as I did the lining. Okay. But it's easier to do it before you sew everything.
Okay, so you've made handles out of a different colour.
Yes. I've got them the same one.
Oh, okay, no, that's fine. It's up to you, yeah.
You can mix and match if you want to.
Yeah.
But just show this one. Yeah. So you have your patterned fabric.
Yeah.
And I think it's like 2.5 inch by 9 inch. Okay. So again, all the measurements are in there. You don't have to worry about anything.
Yeah.
And just because it's rectangles and squares, it's super easy to do. So again, just layer your cream fabric, just the basket fabric.
Uh-huh.
I suppose you could do pattern on both sides
to. If you wanted to, couldn't you?
Go for it, go wild. And then right onto your wadding. And it's just two straight stitches down either side.
Right.
So we'll just do...
Desi says, you are both brilliant. I'm loving this morning. Can you remind me of Jude's Instagram page, please?
Oh, it's The Making Magpie.
The Making Magpie.
Yeah.
The Making Magpie. Is that the best way for people to look at your dungarees and things?
Yeah, so I've got an Etsy.
All right.
Etsy website, yeah. So that's got everything on as well.
And is that called The
Making Magpie? Yeah, everything.
So basically, if they Google Making Magpie, they'll find you some way or the other.
Yeah. Okay. It's just because I love shiny things.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's why.
Yeah.
Because I used to go on walks with my grandma and pick all kinds of things up, like sweet wrappers. You know, them little things off cans and stuff.
Oh, my wrinkles.
She'd come home. Yeah. She'd come home and empty it all into the washing machine. My mum would be like, "Oh God, what are you doing?" Yeah. And it's still the same now.
Oh, is it?
Well, I don't pick things up, but when I see something, I'm like, "Oh."
Yeah, but what you need to do is you need to start looking at diamonds and sapphires and things like that now.
I don't have that kind of money. People buy the dungarees and then I might.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Oh, I've got it stuck here. There we go. Oh, I think I've run out of thread on the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Doesn't matter for now.
You've got some made, haven't you?
I've got some made.
So you've done it down both sides. Mm-hmm. You turn it through.
Turn it inside out, yeah. And then I pressed it just so the edges were nice and clean.
Okay.
And then I also, just to give it a bit more security, because it doesn't really like bend and stuff there, whereas if you've just got it like that, it's too floppy.
Yeah.
Just to give it a bit of security, I stitch down both sides as well.
Top stitch down the side.
Yes.
Perfect.
Just another...
But the ends are still open, the ends are still raw.
Because you're not going to see them, so it's so much easier to turn it inside out when you've got two raw ends as well.
Yeah, post stitch,
because you're not trying to poke in, and we all know how annoying it is.
We do have a primed turning tool, though, which we love, which when you can sew one end up, and it literally just pushes through. It's absolutely brilliant.
I need one.
Yeah, you do.
Honestly, even for doing scrunchies and things like that, it's a nightmare to try and get them all the way through.
Yeah.
When you've got, like, thick cotton as well.
Oh, no, these are brilliant. You need those.
Oh.
And they're only $7.95 or $7.99, aren't they? Something like that. Right.
Bag.
Okay, so you've made your two handles, where the ends are... still raw.
Yeah, okay, both ends still raw. And then this is the tricky bit you've got to remember. So it's still right sides together for sewing as it always is.
Yeah.
So you need your basket flipped the wrong way around.
Right.
So all the seams are completely closed on this one.
Yeah.
And then for this one, you need it right sides in, so you're turning this the yeah. right way around.
So as long as you've got your two right sides together, yeah. that's what you need to check.
Yeah. yeah. So you could do it the other way if you yeah, wanted, yeah. but, and then I just pop mine in.
Right.
But, oh, actually, before we do that, we'll measure the handles. Yeah. In the book, again, it says an inch apart. So if, and this is the same for all of them.
Inch?
Yeah, an inch apart, like either side of the, either side of the seam. And it's
oh, yeah, I see what you mean. I thought you meant that you were going to sew them an inch apart from each other, because that's very close, yeah. So you go find the seam,
yep.
measure an inch that way, measure an inch this way,
yep.
and that's where you, the start of your handles are. Got it?
Super easy. And that's what's good about this one. Like, you can, once you've done one, that's it. You could, I mean, you don't have to make it as big as you want. If you have something, you say, oh, I need a box for this
yeah, or
you
need
whatever.
Between that size and that
yeah.
size, just yourself. Are the handles different sizes? You know, like, the obviously the bodies are all different sizes. Are the handles all the same
no,
size?
No, they're all completely the same.
For whatever size
for
you're doing?
All of them.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it's so easy.
Yeah.
Which way are we at here? So, so easy. Because then, like, you can get all your cutting done at the beginning, so then you're not faffing on.
Yeah, yeah.
It's, oh, then you have to stand up, don't you, to do it. Oh. Nobody wants that when they're in the mood.
So when you're in your sewing room at home, do you make your mum bring you cups of tea and things?
I wish.
Oh?
She wouldn't do that.
Oh, she does everything else for you?
Yeah, I know. She's a good egg.
Oh.
No, I've just got an office.
You've what?
Just like my sister's boyfriend. My sister and her boyfriend have just bought a house and we've built like an office in the garden for like me and her, like a massive workshop.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's nice.
Very lucky.
Are they charging you rent?
Yeah, there will be.
Oh,
I haven't.
No.
Well, I haven't paid for it yet, so
no,
I'm,
exactly.
I'm going to be out of pocket for a while.
Hang on a sec. I've got a message here from who? Sorry. From Julie that says, sorry I'm late to the party, but these baskets, which book do I need? You need the one that's called Weekend Sewing.
Yep.
It's in the graphics at the moment. That's this one. That's 20 quick and easy projects. That's Weekend Sewing. That's this one here. $9.99. The other one, which has got 25 projects in, it's only $8.99, just so you know. But that's this. These bags are in this one. Okay, right.
And then, so once you've got your two, if you can see, two lines either side.
Yeah.
Again, I just do it with a friction pen and then you're not faffing on.
Yeah.
I don't think it really matters which way you position your handles, but I've done it so that...
You've got the floral on the outside of all of these.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, why you wouldn't put it on the inside because you're not going to see them, are you?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I can't remember which way I've done it now. don't call me out.
Yeah.
There. Oh, yeah. So it'll be pattern to the plane.
Yeah.
If you're going to do it this way. And I, on one of them that I saw, and I'd done it just to the edge and I actually missed. I, like, didn't catch part of the handle. So... I would suggest just doing it a little further
a bit
up.
More, yeah.
Just so that you can do it. Because when you've got three layers and also it's all quilted, it's a little bit hard to
yeah.
see on the machine.
And it's all sewn together now as well,
yeah.
so it's going to be a bit more bulky, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, definitely. So it's just a little bit easier to do that. And the pins hold it fine.
Uh-huh.
I've done this one the wrong way.
So now, do you sew over your pins?
I sometimes, but I've snapped that many needles trying to do it, so I try and take them out as I go. But... I mean, if you put them in this way,
yeah.
so they'll go over the machine a lot easier.
Mm.
But still, sometimes your machine just wants revenge on you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So it just thinks, nah.
Trying to tell you not to.
Yeah. So here we go. So again, your lining is the wrong way around. No, the lining's the right way around, the bag's the wrong way
yeah.
around.
But you've got right sides together.
Right sides together. And fingers crossed, it should fit. I like to do the seams first, line
right.
up the two seams, and then at least you know that it's straight.
Yeah.
Again, this is where all your pins come in handy.
Do you ever use little clips? Do you ever use the little...
No, but I'm thinking of getting some because it seems a lot easier.
Yeah, for things like this it is.
Yeah.
It's not so good if you're holding little bits of quilt together, but if you're actually holding...
Prick my knee.
Oh, you're all right.
Yeah, prick my finger then. Oh, I'm fine.
There you go.
Done it many a time.
Do we need the first aid kit? Are you all right?
Oh, no, I'm fine. I'm not bleeding.
Okay. We haven't got a first aider in. Oh, Kat, are you a first aider? Oh, I'm sorry. Kat's the first aider.
I'm so used to doing it, honestly. You just carry on, don't
I know,
you?
I know.
Yeah. And with, even though I've just pinned these handles, I like to take the pins off once I've got the lining fabric in, yeah, and so that you can see where the pin is, so you can exactly actually take it out as you go, mm-hmm, if you're going
to
take,
yeah,
it out.
Yeah, because they're not easy to get to once you're under the machine.
Oh, I know, because and I tend to do it where I forget, and I'm like, oh, God. So you're trying to wrestle with the machine to try and do it. And if you pull the bag outwards,
yeah,
your lining should fit,
yeah,
like, perfectly.
Well, yeah, because you've made them to the same
measurement. It's the same size,
and
yeah,
you've done the same seam allowance, haven't you?
So yeah. So it should be exact. Mm-hmm. And just a little bit fiddly, but all sewing is, isn't it? And then it's just one very simple stitch all the way around. Uh-huh. And because you've got that little gap in the lining fabric where you can turn it around, so you won't even notice. Yeah. You won't see anything.
Go on then.
Oh, let's see what the pins want to do.
Let's see how many needles we break now then.
I know. And I like to start at the seam as well, so then at least you know you've done a full loop. Because
yeah,
if you look into the basket and things as well.
Oh, have you got thread in the bobbin, or to show your bobbin?
Oh, got to do, yeah. Oof. Don't know,
okay, why don't you refill your bobbin? Are you all right? You're going to be all right doing that?
Yeah.
I'll just recap the bundles and everything, yeah, so we don't sit and watch you changing your bobbin. Right, Posy is the most popular. Oh, hang on, that's not Posy, that's Posy. Okay. So you get a metre and a half of your cream-seeded cotton. You get a fat quarter of the yellow, a fat quarter of the white, and a fat quarter of the orange. They're not called that. They're called olive cream and rust. $19.99. Now, obviously, in the bundle, you don't get the book. You're just paying for the bundle of fabric there. Lovely. Then I've got the one that Jude is using, which is the batik bundle. So, again, you get your metre and a half of your cream seeded, and then you get the blue batik, the orange and silver batik, and the green batik for $19.99. Rather lovely, isn't it? Then, finally, the more affordable version is cream, two blues and a green, but it's called Misty Blue. That's where the confusion will be. Oh, no, I suppose that's for your leaves, isn't it? Your Misty Blue's for your leaves. So it's not a mistake. Just move that on. The book that we're... Oh, hang on, that was more affordable. That was $16.99. The book we're working from right now is called Weekend Sewing. That's 20 plus, how can it be 20 plus projects? That's what I want to know. Oh no, but look, I bet they've called that's one project, but there's three different versions within the project maybe. Oh, and this one here, their pot holder's the same shape, but they've got different designs on them. Right, we did have a bundle of both, but now they're available on their own. This one is not brand new, this is the more new, that's not right, Sam. The newer of the two. There's 25 projects in this newer book, and it's £1 cheaper. No, I don't know why. It's not our job to question why, we just do it. We are just the monkeys to the organ grinders upstairs. Oh yeah, we used Starville in the original. The early bird special from today, so you're saving £1. The Stalville doesn't like being on the table, does it? Okay, it's £5.99, saving £1. This is what you get for your £5.99. It will go back up to £6.99 tomorrow. It's half a metre by 72 centimetres. And if you buy two, they're already cut. Okay? Or you can use H640, which is available on the website. Or are you taking the pins out as you're going round now?
Yeah.
I've shamed you into it.
I'm being good. And I'm just trying to adjust these handles because they tend to go diagonally and stuff like that when you're sewing, because the fabric's kind of.
Well, the other thing you've got to remember is because when you're sewing, you kind of think, well, the handles should be on the outside, but actually they're on the inside. You put them inside.
Yeah, I didn't say that, yeah.
No, don't worry.
It's everything, everything's reversed.
Yeah.
There we go. So in theory, it should be fine. But because there's that many layers and sometimes the wadding and things comes away from the... I can't even fire me opening now.
Oh, no.
There we go. Imagine.
Now, before you go, do you trim that... Do you see the seam allowance of the seam that you've just stitched around the top?
Yeah.
Do you trim that down or do you leave it in there?
I've just left it.
Right, okay.
Just because a lot of the times, even though I haven't done on these ones, I usually top stitch.
Oh, yeah.
Just to make it a bit neater.
Yeah, and a bit firmer. It's going to give it that.
Yeah. I just wasn't sure if this one would do it well because it's a bit thicker.
Yeah.
But on this one, it definitely will.
Yeah.
But I feel like if you keep that like centimetre or whatever seam allowance in, then it holds it better, it holds it a bit nicer.
Yeah, yeah.
And you don't really notice it, it's not too bulky. But yeah, I like to just put my hand in, if I can get my little hands in, and feel the seams to begin with to see if like I've missed anything, because there's nothing worse.
Or left a pin in.
Oh yeah, God, there's nothing worse. Then turning it the right way around, stitching it, and then realising you haven't caught something.
Well, like, yeah, exactly.
Oh, so annoying. So, because then you have to unstitch it, and then that's when I just put projects aside and think, oh, I'll do it another day.
Oh, no, so you've got a pile of unfinished projects that have all got something wrong with them.
Always. There we go. So then, once you've got your hole, so everything seems like it should have been sewn, but all will be revealed.
We'll see, won't we? Live on telly. On a Saturday
that
morning.
Put me on pressure.
Yeah.
Here we are. Just a bit fiddly. And obviously with the bigger ones, it's more fiddly, but it all squeezed through. Give it a good shake.
Christine says, good girl, removing the pins.
Thank you.
Oh, now, I once had a piece of needle hit me in the eye when I was doing my apprenticeship in a factory. That was without using pins. That was without using pins. I never sew over them. Well, how did one go in your eye if it was not used? That was without using pins.
She's throwing at herself.
Yeah, blooming Facebook adds words to it, doesn't it? Anyway, Christine, I hope you're all right.
Oh, goodness. Sounds sore. I've never, touch wood.
Touch, oh, no.
I've never been over my finger.
Oh, have you not? Oh, you're not a proper sewer till you've sewn over
That's
your finger.
That's what people say to me, but I just think, well, I'm probably just doing it right.
Oh, good answer.
So there we are.
Yeah.
So it should bag out, and you can push the... Get your hand in while the seam's still open and push all these corners out.
The gap in the lining, would you machine it or hand stitch it?
I machine it because you're not going to see it. And again...
Cat's agreeing with you.
I just get lazy. You know, and your machine's on, it's quick.
Yeah.
If you wanted it to be super neat. But I think if you're using the same colour thread, like this is... I would say this is more of a white fabric than a blue. Then
but as you say, you're never going to see inside it anyway.
You're not going to see it. Who's going to be looking?
Yeah.
So, yeah, you can press it if you want.
Yeah.
But because the top and the bottom of it's already been stitched, the fabric kind of wants to fold in.
Yeah, exactly.
So I just do it on, just to make sure I've got it, I just do it, what was the measurement again? 1/8.
Yeah.
Yeah, just do it on a very small stitch.
It's going to be quick, so we've got to go to Yarn Lane. What I would also say is, you see the way the lining on these has just popped back a little bit?
Yeah.
I'd like to do a top stitch down there so it kind of leaves that trim of binding across the top.
Good idea.
Anyway, listen, I have to say goodbye to you. Thank you so much for
thank
that.
Thank you.
We'll see you again soon, no doubt.
No problem.
Now, I'm not doing a roundup, but I've got to do the menu for tomorrow. Excuse me. Here's tomorrow's Sewing Street menu. Fabrics and pre-cuts at 8 o'clock. 9 o'clock, jean jacket with Mark Francis. 10 o'clock, dressmaking. 11 o'clock, we've got a wrap skirt with Mark Francis. Then 12 o'clock, sewing machines, overlockers and dressmaking tools. There's a what? Yeah, what was the first thing you said? Oh, it's dressmaking bonanza. There's a surprise first thing in the morning. Right, okay, we're now going to Yarn Lane. If you've already bought something from Sewing Street, your post and packaging is paid for on Yarn Lane. If you're watching on the telly, you can stay where you are. If you're watching on YouTube, the Facebook Live or the website, you need to go to the Yarn Lane website. But as I say, your P&P is covered from both. We are doing a crochet along, so go nowhere. We will see you in 4 minutes. Thank you again, Jude. And we will see you in 4 minutes at Yarn Lane.